two-edged sword. It does not return void. That's why we make it available to everybody who would give the plan of salvation to others. Get a multitude of counselors around you, people who are going to help you communicate Christianity, and together pray, read God's Word, fellowship, and then go together with the gospel. You can if you will. It's in your hands. It becomes your decision. It becomes your prerogative to decide to go and share God's plan of salvation. Christ through you can change the world.
For your free copy of the Telling the Truth newsletter, call 812-867-2418, 812-867-2418, or write Triple T, 13,000 U.S. 41 North, Evansville, Indiana, 47725. Find us on the web at tttchristianyouth.org.
Hi, this is Melissa Garrison inviting you to join me for Reflections of Hope, a new daily devotional program Monday through Friday here on The Vine. During Reflections of Hope, we'll apply God's Word to our everyday lives. We all need encouragement and to be strengthened in our faith. So why don't you join me twice daily for Reflections of Hope, right here on local Christian radio, 90.9 The Vine.
Reflections of Hope with Melissa Garrison at 10:05 a.m. and at 1:05 p.m. here on Real Life Radio.
90.9 The Vine is quickly becoming the most listened to radio station in the area. Because people are looking for something positive in their life, and people are finding that positive connection through the music and ministry we play. In fact, the Vine Facebook page has more likes and friends than any other radio station in Wayne County, Jefferson County, Hamilton County, Franklin County, or Clay County. We think that's awesome, and we appreciate our listeners and our underwriting sponsors. If you own or operate a business that would like to partner with The Vine and express your support of this ministry on the air to our faithful audience each day, contact The Vine at 895-3030 or visit our website at wbyn.org.
Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome. It is The Vine Morning Show. Here it is. It's Funday Friday. And it is the 21st day of October. And I'm Mark Wells, and we welcome those that are listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine this morning. And also, we welcome you if you're watching on our in-studio camera this morning. Thanks for tuning in. We're on our website at wbyn.org, our live audio and video stream right now. And you can tune in and watch us or listen to us on the FM channel. Appreciate you listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine and tuning in this morning to our live in-studio camera. It's Funday Friday as Kelley and Jimmy will join me in the studio coming up a little bit later on this morning. And we'll have a Friday riddle. And this week we're going to have a TV show theme song for you. And we have some cool prizes to give away. And your first clue this morning, you'll want to write this down and have it handy. And write down the phone number, too, that we'll have you call in a little bit later on this morning at 895-3030, 895-3030, and identify our TV show theme song this week. And the first clue I'll give you this morning is WoFat. WoFat, your first clue this morning. So write that clue down and that phone number I gave you. And your chance to call in a little bit later on and identify TV show theme song, and then again on Friday riddle. What else are we going to look at today? At-home remedies you may or may not have heard of before, and ways to keep your dog healthy. We'll look at that as well, and also ways you're probably sleeping wrong. Give you some tips on maybe to help you get a better night's rest. And genius uses for ice cubes maybe you had no clue about. And finally this morning we're going to look at facts about the Rubik's Cube. That's what's coming up this morning for you here on The Vine Morning Show. And something else to tell you about that's coming up. A couple of things, actually. Orchardville Church. They're going to be having Judgment House at Orchardville Church. Now, it's going to begin tonight and also Friday, October 28th from 7 to 10 p.m. And then Saturday, October 22nd and October 29th, 6 to 10 p.m. And then on Sunday, October 30th, from 4 to 7 p.m., that's Judgment House at Orchardville Church. Now, if you've never attended a Judgment House before, I highly encourage you to do that. highly encourage you to check that out, all right? So that's coming up. We'll be talking more about that as we go along today. Midwest Food Bank, Fairfield Branch, they're going to be palletizing food at their warehouse facility on Highland Avenue in Fairfield. And that will be Monday, October 24th at 1 p.m. And then again on Tuesday, October 25th at 1 p.m. Now, those interested in volunteering their time is welcome to come and help out. We've got sports on the way coming up for you this morning here on the Vine. Let you know what happened with the Cubs and the Dodgers last night. Some Thursday night NFL football, some local sports as well, and much more for you as Funday Friday here on the Vine Morning Show. The sports coming up next. Area Sports Report on the way, and it is being underwritten this morning by Fairfield National Bank.
Like all of us, Josh and Selena Musgrave had dreams, like secure jobs, raising a family, and a home of their own. As their family grew, so did their desire of being homeowners. With the help of a caring staff, a variety of mortgage options, and having the benefit of keeping decisions local, FNB was there, helping to make their dream a reality, and proving there really is no place like home. FNB. Banking. Business. Life. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Good morning, everyone. Time now to check sports for you on this Friday morning. Well, high school football for this season, regular season, wraps up tonight with a lot of high school games going on in the area. As Johnston City will be in Fairfield tonight, Carmine White County at Cesar Valier. Mount Vernon Rams will take on and tackle the Mount Carmel Aces in Mount Carmel tonight. Centralia will be at Muscoota. El Dorado will be at Chester. Edwards County at Hamilton County. Christopher Ziegler-Ralton will be at Vianna-Gorville. That game will be Saturday at 1 p.m. Also, Freeburg at Salem. Breeze Central at Heron. Pinckneyville will be at DuPo. Trenton Westland at Carlisle. Red Bud at Sparta, Jerseyville at Columbia, Alnio at Casey Westfield, Marshall at Lawrenceville, Red Hill at Flora. Paris will be at Newton, Olympia at Robinson. That'll be Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock. Triad at Belleville-Altoff, Waterloo at Mater Dei, Greenville at Vandalia, Pena at Hillsboro, Litchfield at Carlinville, Southwestern at Roxana. Staunton will be at Gillespie. It will be Carbondale at Harrisburg, Crete Monet at Cahokia, Nashville at West Frankfort, DuCoin at Murfreesboro, Massac County at Carterville, and at Jonesboro will be at Benton, East St. Louis will be in O'Fallon, Belleville East to Collinsville, Alton at Belleville West, Granite City at Edwardsville, Marion at Mattoon, Muhammad Seymour at Effingham, Charleston at Highland, and Civic Memorial in Taylorville, at Taylorville tonight. Those are high school football games wrapping up the regular season. Tonight, high school volleyball action last night. Thompsonville beat Wayne City 2-0. Fairfield a winner over Sisney 2-0. Junior high girls basketball, New Hope beat Sisney 38-22. Now the junior high Jasper shootout going on. The girls game last night, Bluford beat Mount Carmel St. Mary's 39-32. It was New Hope boys beating Mount Carmel St. Mary's 43-11. In the girls game last night, it was Alney St. Joe over Wayne City 36-9. And the boys' game, Alney St. Joe over West Salem, 33-27. That's in the Jasper shootout. Now on the schedule for today, the Jasper shootout, 4:45 this afternoon. In the girls' game, it'll be Sisney and Jasper at 6 o'clock tonight. The boys' game, it'll be Sisney taking on Wayne City. And at 7:15 tonight, the boys' game will be Albion and Flora. And at 8:30, the girls' game will Ab Alney taking on Flora. College volleyball, the Hampton Inn Volleyball Classic at Lincoln College will kick off today. At 3 o'clock, Lincoln will take on Southeastern Community College. At 5 p.m., Highland Community College taking on the Frontier Lady Bobcats. And DuPage at Southeastern will take on Southeastern at that Hampton Classic at Lincoln College, also at 5. At 7, it'll be Lincoln taking on Frontier Lady Bobcats and DuPage taking on Highland. That's in college volleyball, the Hampton Inn Volleyball Classic at Lincoln College. Major League Baseball action from Thursday. Well, the Chicago Cubs are one game away from advancing to the World Series. Now, last night, the Cubs beat the Dodgers in Los Angeles 8-4. Now, the Cubs lead that series 3-2. And now the scene shifts back to Wrigley Field on Saturday. Tomorrow night at 7:08, as the Dodgers will make that trek back to Chicago to take on the Cubs at Wrigley Field tomorrow night. Now the winner between the Dodgers and the Cubs will take on Cleveland in the World Series beginning on Tuesday in Cleveland. NFL football action, Thursday night football. Green Bay Packers, they beat the Bears last night by the score of 26-10. NCAA football, there were a couple of games, actually three games last night. Virginia Tech over Miami, 37-16. Troy over South Alabama, 28-21. And Boise State defeated BYU. Boise State ranked number 14 in the country over BYU, 28-27, the final score there. NBA preseason basketball. It was Orlando beating New Orleans in overtime, 114-111. Charlotte over Miami, 96-88. New York beat Brooklyn, 116-111. And Atlanta beat Chicago, 97-81. National Hockey League scores from last night. Edmonton beat the Blues, 3-1. Boston over New Jersey by the score of 2-1. It was Anaheim beating Philadelphia, 3-2. Pittsburgh over San Jose, 3-2. Montreal over Arizona, 5-2. Colorado beat Tampa Bay, 4-0. It was Washington 4, Florida 2. Minnesota over Toronto, 3-2 in overtime. Los Angeles beat Dallas, 4-3. Carolina over Calgary, 4-2. And Vancouver, winner over Buffalo, 2-1. Don't forget the Sports Couch coming up for you tomorrow morning at 8:30 here on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, as Danny and Randy will be in the studio talking about tonight's high school football games and talking with some area coaches. It's 90 minutes worth of sports talk. The Sports Couch coming up Saturday morning at 8:30 from 8:30 to 10 here on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That's Check Sports for you on this Friday morning. I'm Mark Wells reporting. All right, we're going to come back in a moment, give you the details of the weather forecast as we have a beautiful weekend in store for Southern Illinois. And the area weather is next. The area weather forecast this morning being underwritten by Shoe Creek Pharmacy in Wayne City.
Shoe Creek Pharmacy is your good neighbor pharmacy in downtown Wayne City. Consultations are available on all prescriptions and over-the-counter medications. They are open Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. and on Saturdays from 9 a.m. until 12 noon. Their phone number is 895-2844. Shoe Creek Pharmacy, 310 South Main Street, downtown Wayne City.
Well, the forecast for the Vine listening area as we head into the weekend. All the way through Monday, clear skies. The high temperature today of 59, the high Saturday of 65. Sunday's high warming back up to 75. And then Monday, as we start our week all over again, the high temperature will be 68. Right now in the area, it's a little chilly this morning. Flora at 45, McLeansboro 46, Salem 43, Benton 46, Fairfield 44, and Wayne City right now. It is 44. Here's Phil Wickham. Your Love Awakens Me. Coming up next, right here at The Vine.
90.9 The Vine.
There were walls between us. By the cross you came and broke them down. You broke them down.
Music and ministry that helps you connect with God. It is local Christian radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Your love awakens me. That is Phil Wickham. It is time right now for the Bible verse of the day this morning. It's being underwritten by Jackson Jewelers, and they're located in Mount Vernon.
Jackson Jewelers in Mount Vernon has long been recognized as a diamond headquarters in Jefferson County and the surrounding area. They specialize in engagement rings, wedding rings, and special occasion jewelry. They also buy gold jewelry and can do free appraisals on gold and diamonds. They're also your dealer for Seiko watches, and they have a bridal registry including china, silverware, and many household items. Jackson Jewelers is located in the gallery at 3002 Broadway in Mount Vernon. Their phone number is 244-5430.
And the verse of the day is always on our website at wvyn.org. You can scroll down and see it's in the New International Version, and it's out of the book of Deuteronomy today, chapter 10, verse 21. And it says this: He is your praise, He is your God, who performed for you those great and awesome wonders you saw with your own eyes. That's our verse of the day out of the New International Version, the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verse 21, the verse of the day. It's always on our website at wvyn.org and underwritten Monday through Friday at this time by Jackson Jewelers. And they're located in the gallery at 3002 Broadway in Mount Vernon. Coming up, facts about the Rubik's Cube on the way for this Funday Friday. Ingenious uses for ice cubes you had no clue about coming up. And ways you're probably sleeping wrong, and ways to keep your dog healthy. And finally, at-home remedies you may or may not have ever heard of. That's coming up this morning for you on The Vine. As it is Funday Friday, Kelley and Jimmy will join me in the studio a little bit. We'll have the Friday Riddle and a TV show theme song and your chance to call in a little bit later on and win some cool prizes. And write this number down, 895-3030, 895-3030. That will be the phone number that you will have to call in a little bit later on, and we'll play that TV show theme song for you, a little bit of snippets from it coming up. Your first clue this morning, Woe Fat. Woe Fat, your first clue this morning on our TV show theme song on this Funday Friday. Write that down, have it handy, and we'll give you some additional clues as we go along this morning here on the Vine Morning Show. We're heading into 7 o'clock. Brent McGuire with Newsbreak coming up at 7. Right now, Casting Crowns and One Step Away. It's coming up next right here at the Vine.
What if you could go back and relive one day of your life all over again and unmake the mistake that left you a million miles away from the you you once knew? Now yesterday's shame keeps saying that you'll never get back on track. But what if I told you you one step away from surrender, one step away from coming home, coming home. One step from arms wide open, this love is never.
away. Lay down your old chains. Come now and take up your new name. Your best life up ahead now. You won't step away. Lay down your old chains. Come now and take up your new name. Your best life up ahead now. You won't step away. Just one step away.
Great Christian music that your whole family can enjoy.
Anytime a heart turns from darkness to light, anytime temptation comes and someone stands to fight, anytime somebody lives to serve and not be served, I know, I know, I know, I know.
Personalities.
It's real. They're real people.
Having real conversations.
And they talk about real things.
Real music.
Poetic lyrics about, like, the character and attributes of God.
About real life.
Your music has really touched me today.
Life is real. So is your radio station. Real Life Radio. 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine.
I am. say I'll fall like a million pieces. A ticket, take the ride. Now you're free to fly.
This is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
And now, from the 90.9 The Vine Newsroom, it's Newsbreak. A look at the news you need to know from a positive perspective. This news break is underwritten by Community First Bank of the Heartland.
If your definition of local is Southern Illinois and adjacent states, pay no attention to this message. Hi, I'm Joe David Cummins, President of Community First Bank. Community First Bank is the only local community bank exclusively serving Jefferson County with 5 locations and 5 ATMs. In short, loans and deposits stay local and benefit you.
Community First Bank with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dix, and Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Welcome to your Friday edition of the Vine News Break. I'm Bert McGuire with news that affects you. FNB has been granted naming rights to the Frontier Community College baseball field. The joint announcement was made yesterday morning by FNB President Mike Copeland and Frontier Community College President Dr. Jay Edgren. The Illinois Eastern Community College Board of Trustees approved the naming rights during the monthly meeting held Tuesday night on the campus of Frontier Community College. Friends of the Fairfield Public Library will conduct their semi-annual book and bake sale tomorrow from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. in the library in Fairfield. Books, CDs, DVDs, cassette, and VHS tapes will be sold for $1 each. All proceeds will be used by the library for its programs and purchases. The 7th Annual Women's Conference will be held tomorrow at the First General Baptist Church in Fairfield, with registration to begin at 8:30 a.m. and the program starting at 10 a.m. and running until 2:30 p.m. The $10 registration will cover a soup, salad, and dessert luncheon, prizes, and fun and fellowship. Guest speakers include Sisters Ruby McDowell and Melissa Garrison. Local Mount Vernon grade school students attended the first children's theater production in the new Mount Vernon High School auditorium on Thursday. Some area students attended showings yesterday, while some will attend today. The first show for the general public was last night, with another showing set for 7 p.m. tonight. Pulitzer Prize finalist Lee Martin met with Wren Lake College students yesterday to discuss his novels and creative writing. Martin read excerpts from two of his novels, answered student questions, and did a book signing. Martin also discussed using his Lawrence County, Illinois upbringing and how that shaped his writing. The city of Centralia has been hit with another required improvement to its sewage treatment plant. City Manager Dan Ramey says additional treatment is being required because the EPA wants to make it safe in case someone were to swim in Sewer Creek below the sewage treatment plant. Ramey says the cost of making Sewer Creek safe to swim is estimated to be in the area of $200,000. If you see news happen or have a news item to submit, please call 895-3030 or email your information to newsbreak at wvyn.org. I'm Bert McGuire, and that's today's News Break on 105.5 and 9.9 The Vine.
90.9 The Vine.
Regret. I'm pretty sure we have met. Every single day of your life, I'm the whisper inside that won't let you forget. Hello, my name is Defeat. I know you recognize me. Just when you think you can win, I'll drag you right back down again till you've lost all belief. Oh, these are the voices. Oh, these are the lies. And I have believed them for the very last time.
shoot your words like a gun. Take your aim and shoot if you must. Play this game, cut me down with your lies. Throw your blame, but I'm telling you this won't end well. Cause I'm sheltered in love, I know you are fighting yourself. Call a truce and surrender will sound if you choose to go.
Southern Illinois is home for the best Christian music and the biggest variety. It's local Christian radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That is from the group Satellites and Sirens and their song called Tanks. Welcome in, The Vine Morning Show on a Funday, Friday. I'm Mark, and again, those of you that are listening in on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, and those that are watching this morning on our website, our live in-studio camera, or video streaming at wbyn.org on our live in-studio camera. Thank you for tuning in this morning. Going to be a beautiful day, beautiful weekend in Southern Illinois as temperatures today, we're only going to be up around 59, but plenty of sunshine all the way through Monday. Hey, coming up a little bit later on, Kelley and Jimmy will be joining me in the studio. It's Funday, Friday, where you're going to have a chance a little bit later on this morning to call in and identify our Friday riddle. And we'll have a TV show theme song for you as well on our TV show theme song feature this morning. And we have some cool prizes to give away today. And I gave you a clue earlier this morning, Wolfat. The first clue I gave you, Wolfat. That's your first clue. And let me give you another clue this morning, all right? Let me give you another one. And write these down because, and the phone number as well, 895-3030, 895-3030. And we'll play snippets of that TV show theme song for you coming up in a little while. But Wolfat is your first clue, and I'll give you another one. 1974 Mercury Marquis. You're thinking, all right, have I seen this show before? Well, I'm going to say yes. You probably have.
All right. So WOFAT, your first clue. The second clue, 1974 Mercury Marquee. So what do you think that could be? What do you think that TV show theme song is this morning? Well, you'll find out a little bit later on right here on the Vine Morning Show for Funday Friday. We're also going to look at, do you like the Rubik's Cube? Have you messed with the Rubik's Cube before and you get frustrated sometimes over that because you just can't figure it out? Well, we'll have some facts about the Rubik's Cube coming up. And genius uses for ice cubes you may have no clue about coming up. And ways you're probably sleeping wrong. Now, if you just got up and you just are really tired and you're sore, maybe it was the way you slept overnight. Well, we'll give you some ways you're probably sleeping wrong and ways to keep your dog healthy coming up this morning. And also, finally, we'll look at-home remedies you may or may have never heard of before. That's coming up and much more for you on this Funday Friday right here on the Vine. Now, if you ever want to know what's going on in the area, you can go to our community and Christian event calendar on our website at wvyn.org. And there's a lot of events going on over the weekend as we head into this beautiful weekend. For instance, coming up this morning, and you can go to our community and Christian event calendar and find out, Carmi Family Dental. They are like to invite everyone to their fourth annual Dentistry from the Heart Day. That's today. Now, registration is underway right now, and they've encouraged patients to arrive early. Dress appropriately for the cool weather. Bring your lawn chairs, blankets, snacks, water, etc. This is a day where people have no dental insurance are able to get either an extraction, filling, or cleaning at absolutely no cost. And patients must be at least 18 years of age to participate. That's one event going on today. And let's see, what else is happening today as well in the area? Now, MOPS, M-O-P-S, is a Christ-centered, caring ministry for mothers of children age birth through kindergarten. Now, there is nothing that they would like more than to grow with you. And all moms are invited to join this group, no matter your religion or whether you attend church or not. Have fun. You have fun with them, think with them, talk with them, do with them, and just share your life with them. And no matter what you're going through, what season of life you're in, they would love to meet you. Now, this event is going on today in Mount Vernon at the First United Methodist Church, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Now, if you want any more information, get a hold of Christina Klein, and her phone number is 636-219-2339, 219-2339, 636 area code. Now, there's a lot of events over the weekend on our Community and Christian Event calendar, and we encourage you to go check it out. It's on our website, wvyn.org, and there's an information link right there on the front page you can click to get to it very quickly, all right? It's our Community and Christian Event calendar for you on our website at wvyn.org. More to come this morning here on the Vine Morning Show on this Funday Friday, and we encourage you to stay tuned. More to come, all right? But right now it is time for Kendra Smiley and her program, Live Life Intentionally. It's being underwritten this morning by Wibbles Repair and Sales, and they're located in McLeansboro. 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine thanks Wibbles Repair and Sales in McLeansboro for their monthly underwriting support of local Christian radio. They repair small engines and ag equipment, and they sell small engine parts, including oil filters and belts. They have agriculture aftermarket parts, interstate batteries, big truck parts, and truck lighting. As Steel and Husqvarna dealers, they offer a wide variety of chainsaws, trimmers, and cutoff saws. Wibbles Repair and Sales in McLeansboro. Their phone number, 618-648-2227. Open Monday through Friday, Saturdays till noon.
Welcome to Live Life Intentionally with author and national speaker, Kendra Smiley.
I am a list maker and a goal setter. Maybe you are too. That's not a bad trait to have unless the goals and your personal agenda come before what the Lord has in mind. I remember going to a conference one year with only one goal in mind, your agenda, Lord, not mine. Conference was one of daily networking, and in years gone by, I'd focused only on my agenda. At the end of the meeting, I usually came away with feelings of accomplishment over the goals I'd met and dissatisfaction with those I hadn't. Finally, I wised up and realized that as valuable as my goals might have been, perhaps I was missing something God wanted to show me. Hence,
year of my new goal. Your agenda, Lord, not mine. I attended the conference with great anticipation of what the Lord was going to do, and I did my best to be open to His appointments. Doing that every day is the next right choice.
For more encouragement to make the next right choice.
From Planet Shakers, I know who you are.
No matter what we are going through in our lives, in every season, God is there. Whatever I face, I have hope. When I'm sick, He is my healer. He is my joy. When I don't have much left, He provides. This song is all about the unfailing character of our God. He is the one we can rely on, the one we can depend on, and the one that we worship. I know who you are.
I know who you are. Planet Shakers on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine.
I might be halfway through this valley, and my eyes just can't see a quick way out. And it might seem life's got it out for me, like I'm way too deep, but I have found every single circumstance I can place in greater hands. I won't let my trouble bring me down. I've got joy down in my soul. I'm gonna take it everywhere I go. Not gonna worry about what I don't know. I'll be alright as long as just cast my cares, won't sink into despair. I won't find answers there, only doubt. Every single circumstance I can place in greater hands. God, I know He'll never let me down. I've got joy down in my soul. I'm gonna take it everywhere I go. Not gonna worry about what I don't know. I'll be alright as long as no matter how I feel, gonna be my strength, be my truth, gonna light the way, see me through.
It's like a constant war, and you want.
wanna settle that score. But you're bruised and beaten, and you feel defeated. This goes out to the heaviest heart.
Christian Radio, that is listener-supported, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. It's Not Over, that is for King and Country. It is 727, and I want to remind you, Midwest Food Bank Fairfield Branch, they're going to be palletizing food at their warehouse facility. Highland Avenue in Fairfield coming up Monday and Tuesday, both at 1 o'clock next week. Now, those interested in volunteering their time is welcome to come and help out.
Real Life Radio is thankful for the financial partnership we have with Greenwald & Sons Construction in Wayne City and in Mount Vernon. They specialize in residential and commercial construction and remodeling. They have a long list of satisfied customers spanning over 38 years. Whether it's a church addition, business expansion, or new home construction, Greenwald & Sons Construction of Wayne City and Mount Vernon are experts that you can depend on. Their phone number is 895-2044, and we thank them for their support of local Christian radio.
Mark Dinsmore, Country Financial in Wayne City, is a faithful underwriting sponsor of 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Mark Dinsmore, Country Financial, is your full-service insurance provider, from home and auto to life and health to a full line of financial and retirement products. Mark Dinsmore, Country Financial, is located at 210 North Main in Wayne City, and their phone number is 895-2989.
Hi, this is Ken Gordon, worship leader at Christian Fellowship Church in Mount Vernon. At CFC, it is our desire to see men and women become true disciples of our Lord Jesus Christ. On Sunday, we have adult Bible study and Sunday school for children at 9 a.m., followed by worship at 10. For more information, please visit our website at mvcfc.org or call us at 244-7466. Please join us at Christian Fellowship Church, where every member is a minister.
Hamilton County Flooring, on the south side of the square in McLeansboro, offers a full line of flooring, cabinets, and countertops for your home or business. Countertops or showers are available in granite, quartz, Corian, custom marble, or ceramic tile. Their showroom includes a complete line of flooring available in ceramic tile, cork, bamboo, hardwood, vinyl, laminate, and carpeting, including name brands such as Armstrong, Bruce, Marazzi, Mulligan, Shaw, and Tarquette. We thank Hamilton County Flooring in McLeansboro for their support.
Proverbs 31 Ministries is a daily dose of encouragement from Lisa Turkhurst and Renee Swope. And the one-minute feature this morning is being underwritten by The Medicine Shop in Fairfield.
Nearly everyone has a smartphone these days, and there is an app for almost everything. Well, prescription refills are made easy at The Medicine Shop and Ed's RX in Fairfield. They have an app that will simplify your life. Drop off your prescription or call it in, and they will text you when your prescription is ready. They even can sync all of your prescriptions together so that your refills will be handled more conveniently for your schedule. Refills made easy at The Medicine Shop Pharmacy and Ed's RX in Fairfield.
I felt completely left out. Hi, I'm Lisa Turkhurst with Proverbs 31 Ministries. I was in middle school, and one day I saw these girls that I thought were my friends going to a birthday party, complete with bowling, pizza, and a sleepover. But I wasn't invited. I tried to tell myself all day that it really wasn't a big deal, but that night I found myself sitting at home, alone, thinking about how I wasn't invited, I wasn't chosen, I wasn't liked. Here's what I wish I could have told myself back then, and what I need to remember when negative thoughts creep in today. Don't put the whole of your identity into the smallness of this situation. Colossians 2:10 teaches that we have been given fullness in Christ. I can place the wholeness of my identity in that reality and see everything else as small in comparison. To find more healthy perspectives on everyday life issues, visit Proverbs 31 Ministries at proverbs31.org.
More music and ministry for Fairfield, Mount Vernon, and McLeansboro.
90.9 The Vine.
Impossible!
Good morning, everyone. Time now to check sports for you on this Friday morning. Well, high school football for this season, regular season, wraps up tonight with a lot of high school games going on in the area. As Johnston City will be in Fairfield tonight, Carmi White County at Cesar Valier. Mount Vernon Rams will take on and tackle the Mount Carmel Aces in Mount Carmel tonight. Centralia will be at Muscoota. El Dorado will be at Chester. Edwards County at Hamilton County. Christopher Ziegler-Ralton will be at Vianna-Gorville. That game will be Saturday at 1 p.m. Also, Freeburg at Salem, Breeze Central at Heron, Pinckneyville will be at DuPo, Trenton Westland at Carlisle, Red Bud at Sparta, Jerseyville at Columbia, Alnio at Casey Westfield, Marshall at Lawrenceville, Red Hill at Flora. Paris will be at Newton, Olympia at Robinson, that'll be Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock. Triad at Belleville-Altoff, Waterloo at Mater Dei, Greenville at Vandalia, Pena at Hillsboro, Litchfield at Carlinville, Southwestern at Roxana. Staunton will be at Gillespie. It will be Carbondale at Harrisburg, Crete Monet at Cahokia, Nashville at West Frankfort, DeCoin at Murfreesboro, Massac County at Carterville, and at Jonesboro will be at Benton, East St. Louis will be in O'Fallon, Belleville East at Collinsville, Alton at Belleville West, Granite City at Edwardsville, Marion at Mattoon, Muhammad Seymour at Effingham, Charleston at Highland, and Civic Memorial in Taylorville, at Taylorville tonight. Those are high school football games wrapping up the regular season tonight. High school volleyball action last night. Thompsonville beat Wayne City 2-0. Fairfield a winner over Sisney 2-0. Junior high girls basketball. New Hope beat Sisney 38-22. Now the junior high Jasper shootout going on. The girls game last night. Bluford beat Mount Carmel St. Mary's 39-32. It was New Hope boys beating Mount Carmel St. Mary's 43-11. In the girls game last night, it was Alney St. Joe over Wayne City 36-9. And the boys' game, Alney St. Joe over West Salem, 33-27. That's in the Jasper shootout. Now on the schedule for today, the Jasper shootout, 4:45 this afternoon. In the girls' game, it'll be Sisney and Jasper at 6 o'clock tonight. The boys' game, it'll be Sisney taking on Wayne City. And at 7:15 tonight, the boys' game will be Albion and Flora. And at 8:30, the girls' game will Ab Alney taking on Flora. College volleyball, the Hampton Inn Volleyball Classic at Lincoln College will kick off today. At 3 o'clock, Lincoln will take on Southeastern Community College. At 5 p.m., Highland Community College taking on the Frontier Lady Bobcats. And DuPage at Southeastern will take on Southeastern at that Hampton Classic at Lincoln College, also at 5. At 7, it'll be Lincoln taking on Frontier Lady Bobcats and DuPage taking on Highland. That's in college volleyball, the Hampton Inn Volleyball Classic at Lincoln College. Major League Baseball action from Thursday. Well, the Chicago Cubs are one game away from advancing to the World Series. Now, last night, the Cubs beat the Dodgers in Los Angeles 8-4. Now, the Cubs lead that series 3-2. And now the scene shifts back to Wrigley Field on Saturday, tomorrow night at 7:08, as the Dodgers will make that trek back to Chicago, take on the Cubs at Wrigley Field tomorrow night. Now the winner between the Dodgers and the Cubs will take on Cleveland in the World Series beginning on Tuesday in Cleveland. NFL football action Thursday night football. Green Bay Packers, they beat the Bears last night by the score of 26-10. NCAA football, there were a couple of games, actually 3 games last night. Virginia Tech over Miami, 37-16. Troy over South Alabama, 28-21. And Boise State defeated BYU. Boise State ranked number 14 in the country over BYU, 28-27, the final score there. NBA preseason basketball, it was Orlando beating New Orleans in overtime, 114-111. Charlotte over Miami, 96-88. New York beat Brooklyn, 116-111. And Atlanta beat Chicago, 97-81. National Hockey League scores from last night. Edmonton beat the Blues, 3-1. Boston over New Jersey by the score of 2-1. It was Anaheim beating Philadelphia, 3-2. Pittsburgh over San Jose, 3-2. Montreal over Arizona, 5-2. Colorado beat Tampa Bay, 4-0. It was Washington 4, Florida 2. Minnesota over Toronto 3-2 in overtime. Los Angeles beat Dallas 4-3. Carolina over Calgary 4-2. And Vancouver winner over Buffalo 2-1. Don't forget the Sports Couch coming up for you tomorrow morning at 8:30 here on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, as Danny and Randy will be in the studio talking about tonight's high school football games and talking with some area coaches. It's 90 minutes worth of sports talk. The Sports Couch coming up Saturday morning at 8:30 from 8:30 to 10 here on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That's Check Sports for you on this Friday morning. I'm Mark Wells reporting.
Hi, I'm Rebecca West, Children's Director here at Orchardville Church. Do you or your family need a better understanding of God's Word? I would like to invite you to Orchardville Church, where your whole family can learn at any age. We begin our teachings even in the nurseries. If you do not have a church you can call your home, we want you to come and be a part of our family. Sunday school begins at 9 a.m. and worship is at 10. We hope to see you. Check us out on ochurch.com and Facebook.
I trust in Jesus.
Time now to check the area weather forecast. Underwritten by Home Source Warehouse, they're located in Mount Vernon.
Monthly financial support of local Christian radio is provided by Home Source Warehouse in Mount Vernon. Located 4 miles north of Mount Vernon on Route 37, Home Source Warehouse offers a warehouse full of quality furniture and mattresses with legendary service. Open Thursday and Friday 10 to 6, Saturday 10 to 3. You can find them on Facebook, and their website is homesourcewarehouse.net. Their phone number is 204-5515. Home Source Warehouse, where style is affordable.
Southern Illinois weather.
Well, beautiful day this whole entire weekend. Clear skies all the way through Monday. We'll have a high of 59 today, 65 tomorrow, 75 on Sunday, and then Monday as we begin the brand new week. Clear sky, 68. Right now in the area, Carmi at 44. Mount Vernon, 43. Flora, 44. Fairfield, 43. In Wayne City right now, it is 45. Here's Plum, Great Is Our God, coming up next right here at The Vine.
Our God.
That is Plum from Real Life Radio, 105.5 and 90.9. The Vine. Great is our God. It is time right now for To Your Health with Lyle Dean. A one-minute feature this morning is being underwritten by Fairfield Memorial Hospital.
Join Fairfield Memorial Hospital for an open house event for the new Urgent Care on Thursday, October 27th from 5 to 8 p.m. with a ribbon cutting at 5. Meet and greet the providers and staff who will be caring for you and enjoy nice refreshments. This is Physician Assistant James Hopper, and on behalf of the Urgent Care team, we look forward to meeting our community neighbors at the Urgent Care open house event Thursday, October 27th from 5 to 8 p.m. Fairfield Memorial Hospital, excellence in community health care.
People with diabetes, including those without known cardiovascular disease, have a very high risk of heart attack or stroke. But nearly 2 out of 5 such people who could benefit from statins do not take those medicines. A research letter in the Journal of the American College of Cardiology says previous studies have shown taking a statin can significantly cut the risk of a future cardiovascular event in people with diabetes. 38% of diabetics in this study were not on a statin, which could be life-saving. The American Heart Association, the American College of Cardiology, and the American Diabetes Association recommend statins for adults between 40 and 75 who have diabetes. To Your Health, a community service of Fairfield Memorial Hospital and WVYN The Vine. I'm Lyle Dean.
And good morning and welcome back to Vine Morning Show. It is Funday Friday as we end the week and head into a beautiful weekend. I'm Mark and there's Kelley. Good morning, Kelley, and how are you this morning?
Oh, good morning, Mark, and good morning to all of our listeners out there.
Our listeners, and not only our listeners, but our viewers as well.
Too. Yeah.
We're on our live studio camera this morning as we're video streaming on our website as well, wbyn.org. Someone asked me the other day, how do I access that? Okay, real quickly, you just go to our website, wbyn.org, and where it says live in studio camera, you just click on right there.
And here we are.
And here we are. We're live.
Yes.
Now you can see, you can go back and watch archived
shows
as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a great new feature we have here on the Vine, and we're enjoying it. But yeah, someone asked me the other day, and so there you go. It's very simple. So how are you this morning?
I am great. Good. I'm enjoying this weather.
Hey, you know, it was cool this morning. It's now jacket weather.
I love it. It's refreshing.
2 days in a row now, I've had to take my jacket with me. And that's okay.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
You know, I was outdoors working yesterday, and it was a little chilly.
A little chilly yesterday.
My hands were cold.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, I thought, wow, it's time. It's here.
Yes.
And then just in the beginning of the week, I was extremely hot.
Well, we leave our temperature in our home, our thermostat set at 68 year round. And I was a little chilly. When was that? Let me think here. Tuesday evening.
Did you turn the heat on?
No. No.
Oh, I haven't done that yet.
And I wanted to. And Sherry was in the kitchen cleaning up dinner dishes. And I walked by and she said, what are you doing? I was looking on the wall. I was looking at the thermostat. And she says, what are you doing? And I says, I'm just looking at the thermostat. She says, don't touch that.
I know.
She says, if you're cold, what'd she tell me? Go put on more clothes.
That's what I said. I even had the window open in the kitchen last night. Getting some of that cool, fresh air in because the house had been shut up all day. And what's Dennis doing? Don't you think that's open too much?
Uh-huh.
And then he said, I'm going to have to shut it halfway. I said, okay, and then you need to go get more clothes on. Well, because I'm enjoying this. I love it.
I was running around the house in shorts.
Yep.
And then I ended up with my sweatpants on after she told me, go put more clothes on. And I knew it was coming because there was that pause. And I was already heading to the bedroom whenever she was saying that. So.
This is such good sleeping weather.
Not. It is nice. It is nice.
Yesterday morning, I had to get up early and get out early for the day. And I wanted to stay in bed so bad because it was one of those mornings where it was dark and gloomy and thunder and a little bit of lightning. And, I wanted to stay in bed so bad.
Yes.
And then this morning was kind of the same way because it was so chilly.
Yeah.
But I've had to make it early mornings the last 2 days. But
I'll sleep in one morning coming up. I like it when it's cool and you're underneath the covers and you're just all comfy.
Yeah, nothing like sleeping in a cool bed and getting comfortable.
And a cool room.
Sure, sure.
Love it.
Yeah, but you know, it's going to be a beautiful weekend all the way through. Clear skies all weekend long. So
perfect weather. Total sunshine coming up for the next week, I believe.
Yeah, and you know, we're going to have some rain by May. Of course, you know, we know the weather forecast can change. We understand that.
Yeah, the rain might go away.
Yeah, but
they can always predict it, but it don't always happen. Well,
we're going to have beautiful days and kind of cool nights, but not bad at all for this time of year, you know. So it's It's time to turn because there's a lot of sickness going around.
Oh, yes, there is. A lot of vomiting kids.
Yes, yes. A lot of sickness, a lot of earaches, a lot of sore throats at this point in time of the year. Allergies. And the farmer's been working in the field, too.
And yes, trying to lots and lots of allergies.
Yeah. Hey, do you have any clue on our TV show theme song today?
Yes, I do. I told you when I came in, I believe I know it. Well, I know it.
Well, now, it's tricky now.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, and let me explain here. Let me give you another clue here.
That's where you're going to get everybody here.
Yeah, this is where we're going to get everybody. Now, you got to be, it's one of those, you have to be specific, okay? But either way, someone's going to get it.
Mm-hmm.
But this show aired on CBS from 1968 to 1980, okay?
Yeah,
1968 to 1980, all right?
And I love the music to it.
Oh, yeah. And there's another clue to go along with that. And
I don't think you need to give any more, really.
Yeah, but do you know? Well, do you know? We know because we discussed this off the air, but don't say it. Don't say it. Do you know who wrote the theme song?
Oh, I don't.
Aha! There's a clue. There's another one for you. I know. Used to spin it in secular radio. Oops. Might give that away. Yeah. Anyway, let me give you these other clues here, okay? The two I gave earlier. Wolfat. Wolfat. And a 1974 Mercury Marquis.
Yep.
All right. And I think the third clue will give it away.
Well, you better not, because I already feel like the first clue gives it away.
Yeah, but again,
you got to figure out which one.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes,
which one? You know, we're giving some additional clues here. But anyway, yeah, we've got some cool prizes to give away this morning. We've got a gift certificate from Ray's Doghouse in Fairfield.
What's our music today?
Citizen Way CD.
Ah, okay,
good. Those guys are good. And a courtesy of Daystar Christian Bookstore in Mount Vernon and our friends over there, we have a God's Not Dead 2 Bible book cover as well.
And our Country Bob's sauce.
Yes, our friends up in Centralia, Country Bob's. We have Country Bob's original all-purpose sauce. Good stuff. I had some of that the other night.
I know. I'm always pulling it out, the barbecue sauce or the steak sauce.
You know what the barbecue? You know what the all-purpose sauce is?
All-purpose is what I pull out.
What do you know? What it's good on?
Oh, everything.
It's good on everything. French fries. It's even good for French fries.
Well, that's funny you say that because I like it on mashed potatoes.
That's you know what I was getting ready to say that.
Yeah,
mashed potatoes is good.
Mm-hmm.
Baked potato. It's good on a baked potato.
Yeah. Just gives it a little zing.
Yeah, zing, zap, zoom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good.
It's really good. It's really good stuff, yeah.
Oh, we forgot. We got car washes, too. I brought in two $10 car washes from Wattawash.
That goes
along with the prize packets.
And those watching on our website this morning, and we've got graphics to show you what everything you will win. It's right above Kelley's head. The graphic is this morning. Fun Day Friday is just right above your head. I fit it perfectly.
Oh, great.
I can still see your hair. No interruptions.
How'd you set that up like that?
I don't know. So I thought, I need to go a little higher. Okay, we're good right there. So see, you can see it.
I do. I see it.
See? No, it's not blocking anything out of you. See? it's like a mirror. Yeah.
That's fun.
Yeah. You're like a little kid who sees himself
like
in a mirror.
Like a little ghost on the wall.
Yeah, a little ghost on the wall or in those shadow. What are those things called? Shadow silhouettes or something like that.
It's been so long ago.
Yeah. Hey, Jimmy will be here in just a little while as well. He's running a little bit behind. But, that's what we... And also, we're going to look at...
You've got some good stuff.
I do.
Because some of it I'm really interested in.
Yeah. At Home Remedies, maybe you have or have never heard of. Okay,
we'll check those out.
Yeah, those are good. Facts about the Rubik's Cube coming up.
I don't know anything about that.
Genius uses for ice cubes you had no clue about, possibly.
Well, now that just really, I'm anxious to know those.
Ways you're sleeping wrong, probably.
Oh.
Coming up, yeah. And ways to keep your dog healthy.
Oh, got to know that.
You know what? Let's look at that real quick here. You know,
yeah, because I probably do things I'm not supposed to.
Well, you know, these are, you know, and always, as we throw in the disclaimer here, always check with your vet, okay? Mm-hmm. It's very good. Check with your vet on anything such as that, all right? But here's a way to keep your dog healthy, and I would have never thought of this, but it makes perfect sense. To keep your dog hydrated, Pedialyte, like you give babies. Now, if your dog suffers from mild dehydration, signs include a dry mouth, panting, and a loss of skin elasticity, okay? Pour Pedialyte into his or her bowl to quickly replace electrolytes.
And I just wouldn't think they drank it because, gosh, my kids never would even drink that stuff.
Really?
Uh-uh.
Well, drinking water will replace most electrolytes, but drinking this solution formulated for babies quickly replaces minerals like potassium and sodium.
Mm, it would be good for them.
Yeah, yeah. Now, to get stickers and burrs out of fur, all vegetable shortening.
I just go for the scissors.
Give them a haircut. We'll try this next time. To remove
shortening.
Burrs, yeah.
Like Crisco.
All vegetable shortening. To remove burrs from your dog's coat, wear work gloves to avoid getting pricked by the burrs, of course. Work a dab of shortening into the affected areas and then pry the burrs loose.
That would work. Or coconut oil, I bet.
Yeah, I bet it would, too. Shampoo your dog to remove the vegetable shortening.
Hmm.
Yeah. To curb chewing. You know, dogs that chew on maybe.
Tell me.
Yeah. You know, if you've got stuff around furniture or whatever your dog likes to chew, listen to this. I've never thought of this before. Bengay. You know.
Let him chew on a tube of Bengay.
Not on the tube.
Oh.
You'll really make him sick. You want to keep
rub it in there.
You want to keep him healthy now, remember. All right, here we go. Coat the object with a dab, not the whole tube of Bengay. Yeah, just get a little bit in the. Say here, Fido. Here, eat some Bengay.
Makes him not want it.
The smell will repel him. Now here's something else you can try.
Huh.
White vinegar and apple cider vinegar.
So spray that about on anything, and they won't want to chew on it.
Yeah, that's right. Spray the solution on whatever furniture your dog likes to chew. Shake well. You mix 5 ounces of white vinegar, 5 ounces of apple cider vinegar, and 5 ounces of water in a 16-ounce trigger spray bottle. So if you don't have Bengay, you can use that. But yeah, not the whole tube, Kelley.
Bengay.
We're keeping him healthy.
What? What's in that that makes him not want to?
It's the smell. Have you ever had Bengay on your own?
Burn?
Oh,
like,
yeah, it's like heat. It's like a...
wonder. Yeah. Like biofreeze, kind of like.
Yeah, exactly.
So that would leave an awful taste in their mouth. No wonder.
Yeah, the smell will repel them, yeah.
Oh, man.
Now, you probably... Here's one to eliminate fleas. We all have this around our home. Dawn dishwashing liquid. Yeah.
Okay.
You just add a small amount of Dawn dishwashing liquid under running water to fill a sink or bathtub and give your dog a bath in the soapy solution. You work the lather into the coat and let it soak for more than 5 minutes. Now the soap penetrates the exoskeletons of fleas, killing them, and works more effectively than some prescribed flea shampoos.
Dawn dishwashing does everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You hear it for anything.
Now, here's something else you can do. Now, if your pet gets bubble gum stuck to his or her paw or fur, use a few drops of Dawn to dissolve it. It also works.
Huh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, and let's do one more, and then we're heading to 8 o'clock. To prevent another accident, strategically place trash bags. Now, to keep your dog off any area of the carpet or floor where he or she has previously left a mess, cut open a trash bag along the seams and cover the spot with plastic. Dogs despise the feeling of plastic, and they will stay away.
Oh, it scares them, too, I'm noticing.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they think they're going to fall.
Put a trash bag in a trash can.
Mm-hmm.
One of my dogs now doesn't want to run by the trash can because it's afraid of it because I was, you know, opening it up and making the noise.
Mm-hmm.
And now she just runs real fast and skids across the... Mm-hmm.
The floor, the trash can,
yeah,
the bag?
Yeah, the floor, whatever. It's not tile, but
sure.
Linoleum, whatever.
Right.
And it scares her, and she slides by it.
Really? Now, does your dog like the vacuum, by chance?
All of them are fine with it.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Now, some are scared or want to bite at it.
Yeah, now...
No, mine are... I vacuum so much, they're all used to it.
Ollie, he'll chase it. Belmont runs the other way. Ollie likes to chase it. He barks at it.
Oh.
Yeah, he barks at it. And he'll lay down by it as it's going by, and then he'll scoot along with it, and then he barks at it. And but they do not like the attachments.
They probably want to get after those.
They're afraid of them. You know, some dogs like the attachments run over them, like, you know, it's kind of brushing them.
Yeah.
But that that loud noise scares them. I guess
that was good.
I don't know. Yeah. Woo. Yeah, woo! But anyway, yeah, he likes to lay right by it, and then he'll kind of move along with it, and then he barks at it. I think he's trying to make communication, like talk with it.
Yes.
So anyway.
He's trying to get on the vacuum's level.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Yeah, when the light comes on, then he knows that thing's alive. And
it is funny to watch some animals with the vacuum cleaner, though.
It is, yeah.
Some, it just scares them to death, and some just... Like, and my cat, too. I can just run it right up next to her. She just sits there and looks at it.
Well, Sherry has a girlfriend, and her girlfriend says anytime that they run a vacuum in their home, the cat will jump on the front and ride along.
Now, that is crazy.
That's
for
crazy.
A cat.
You never heard of that before?
No.
And so we saw a picture of it one time, the cat just laying on the front of the vacuum
as
they're pushing.
Funny.
And I think maybe it's because it's warm and they can feel the warmth against their body.
Yeah.
And they like that. They like the warmth. All right. Hey, it's 8 o'clock. We're going to move on. We'll come back here in just a moment. And Jimmy will join us in the studio coming up in a little bit. Funday Friday. It's Mark, Kelley, and soon to be Jimmy. More to come. The Vine Morning Show on a Funday Friday from Real Life Radio.
This is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
The best Christian music, 90.9.
And now, from the 90.9 The Vine Newsroom, it's Newsbreak. All the news you need to know from a positive perspective. This Newsbreak is made possible by the Medicine Shop Pharmacy in Fairfield. Nearly everyone has a smartphone these days, and there is an app for almost everything. Well, prescription refills are made easy at the Medicine Shop and EdsRx in Fairfield. They have an app that will simplify your life. Drop off your prescription or call it in, and they will text you when your prescription is ready. They even can sync all of your prescriptions together so that your refills will be handled more conveniently for your schedule. Refills made easy at the Medicine Shop Pharmacy and EdsRx in Fairfield.
Welcome to your Friday edition of the Vine News Break. I'm Bert McGuire with news that affects you. FNB has been granted naming rights to the Frontier Community College baseball field. The joint announcement was made yesterday morning by FNB President Mike Copeland and Frontier Community College President Dr. Jay Edgren. Illinois Eastern Community College Board of Trustees approved the naming rights during the monthly meeting held Tuesday night on the campus of Frontier Community College. Friends of the Fairfield Public Library will conduct their semi-annual book and bake sale tomorrow from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. in the library in Fairfield. Books, CDs, DVDs, cassette, and VHS tapes will be sold for $1 each. All proceeds will be used by the library for its programs and purchases. The 7th Annual Women's Conference will be held tomorrow at the First General Baptist Church in Fairfield, with registration to begin at 8:30 a.m. and the program starting at 10 a.m. and running until 2:30 p.m. The $10 registration will cover a soup, salad, and dessert luncheon, prizes, and fun and fellowship. Guest speakers include Sisters Ruby McDowell and Melissa Garrison. Local Mount Vernon grade school students attended the first children's theater production in the new Mount Vernon High School auditorium on Thursday. Some area students attended showings yesterday, while some will attend today. The first show for the general public was last night, with another showing set for 7 p.m. tonight. Pulitzer Prize finalist Lee Martin met with Rent Lake College students yesterday to discuss his novels and creative writing. Martin read excerpts from two of his novels, answered student questions, and did a book signing. Martin also discussed using his Lawrence County, Illinois upbringing and how that shaped his writing. The city of Centralia has been hit with another required improvement to its sewage treatment plant. City Manager Dan Ramey says additional treatment is being required because the EPA wants to make it safe in case someone were to swim in Sewer Creek below the sewage treatment plant. Ramey says the cost of making Sewer Creek safe to swim is estimated to be in the area of $200,000. If you see news happen or have a news item to submit, please call 895-3030 or email your information to newsbreak@wvyn.org. I'm Bert McGuire, and that's today's Newsbreak on 105.5 and 9.9 The Vine.
90.9 The Vine.
I just can't believe where my life was at. All that I know is my heart was broken. I don't ever want to go back. Ain't no explanation how I saw the light. He found me and set me free, and he brought me back to life. Blame it on the transformation, changed down to the core. This love is real and I can't sit still, cause my name's not shame no more. God Almighty done change this. Great God Almighty done change this. You gotta change, change, change. Like you change, change, change. Brand new look so good on you. It's a shame that you've been changed. Come on and shake, shake like you change. Shake, shake like you change. Man, he came to you when everything seemed fine.
Music and ministry that helps you connect with God. It is local Christian radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That is from Mercy Me and their song called Shake. It is 8:10, and it's The Vine Morning Show. Here we are. It's Funday Friday. I'm Mark, along with Kelley and Jim. And Jimmy made it in. Good morning, Jimmy.
Good morning.
Hey, and hey, we're on
hello
live.
Hello to all
yes.
the viewers.
All the viewers on our in-studio camera this morning. And it's good to see you guys, and You have no clue what today's TV show theme song is, right? We stumped you today.
As of right now, I do not. And I told you off the air when I walked in, I said, I have no clue. It's like, what does low fat have to do with the 1974 Mercury Marquis?
It's, yeah.
But you said you were going to clarify.
Yeah, it's not low fat, it's whoa fat. Okay. W-O-F-A-T.
Well, let me say, I thought when you said the clue yesterday on your little video, that I had to watch your video a couple times to make sure you were saying low fat, because I thought you said low fat.
Well, low.
I'm glad
and
we
low.
Clarified that, because I'm sure there's other listeners out. Sure. Not that you talk funny or anything. Yeah. You that don't. Did you not get... like Kelley, but no.
I'm
teasing. But no, it did sound like low fat, but it's whoa fat.
Like when you move your mouth, low and whoa come out the same way.
Exactly.
You have to whoa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa fat.
Whoa fat. Yeah. Whoa fat. Yeah, so you have no clue what it is.
As of right now, no. You mentioned something about the writer of the song.
Yes.
Who's the songwriter?
I can't tell you.
He won't tell.
He'll give it away. I can't tell you.
I love the theme song.
Yeah.
Well,
it gives it away.
Yeah, so it gives it away.
So, I mean, so.
I think
so. What if it gives it away?
Yeah. I think WoFat gives it away.
I think the other clue will give it away that we haven't mentioned yet. Because 1974 Mercury Marquis can cover just many shows with that kind of a car in it.
But you only got one.
It ran from 68 to 80,
you said, on CBS.
And you only have one WoFat, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. One WoFat. WoFat. Yes. So anyway, I'll tell you what. I'll give you another clue. I wasn't going to do this, but I will do that. The group who did the theme song, they were called The Ventures. We're going to be giving it away. Someone's going to get this. Don't call in yet. It's not time to call, but we'll let you know. Jimmy's really thinking hard about that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. So anyway, those are your first two clues. Actually, three.
The Ventures, not the Adventures, but The Ventures.
The Ventures, yes. The Ventures.
Yeah, that's close.
The Adventures.
The clues were Ventures, 1974 Mercury Marquis, and Whoa, W-O, Fat.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I just want to start
singing
the...
You want to start singing it. You'll know it when you hear it. You've got to know it. Could be a trick one for someone, but we'll play that theme song coming up in a little bit. Hey, did you wake up in a good mood this morning? Did you wake up sore or anything like that? Like body parts sore?
Well, I woke up exhausted.
I woke up cold.
Friday.
Cold? Yeah. Exhausted because it's Friday. You're supposed to be, you're rejuvenated.
It's the weekend.
Yeah.
I know, but when I get through this today, I'll be energized. I got a lot of work to do today. So.
She keeps talking about this work. I don't think you know what it means.
Even though I did see you at your best yesterday.
You did.
Working.
He was working hard, huh? Yes, working hard.
And I didn't see you.
No, you didn't. And I was in there for a long time ordering my glasses, and then Dennis was getting his eye exam, and then he went to order his glasses. And meanwhile, I went to my office to do work.
Oh, okay.
Make calls and everything, which was the truck. So I had to set out there, and one of my big adventures was on the phone to the insurance company yesterday.
Oh, wow.
Health insurance.
Health insurance.
Getting reinstated and all this stuff, and it's like, oh my goodness, that right there takes an hour of your time. So I was getting her done yesterday.
Okay.
So when I was waiting for him to be picking his glasses out and seeing you running all over the place.
But see, you needed to be in there.
He kept running out to the truck,
to pick
and I was
out.
Like, I'm on hold. Just get him. But I ran in at the end, and I liked what he got. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Well, good.
So we're good.
You got new glasses.
We're going to be wearing our glasses as of next week. I cannot wait.
All right. Good deal. Well, you know, glasses can play an important part in your daily life, too, because it helps you see better, increase your vision.
Especially if you're watching and seeing the thermostat on the wall.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, what temperature is that? I'm surprised you didn't throw that up. Hey, maybe you need to get your eyes tested.
Yeah.
Why are you squinting? Yeah, you're 2 inches from it, and you're squinting.
Yeah. Oh, I'm just going to be so happy. And you know what? A friend of mine walked in the door when I was looking at frames, and I said, I didn't know you wore glasses. And she says, I'm just getting them. And I go, okay, I know why, because you're just a little above 45 now, right? And she says, yep, 47. I said, it all goes at 45. Yeah. Your vision does.
Yeah.
Almost on anybody you talk. Not necessarily true. Well, no. Just a lot of the average people, it seems like, when they go to look at something close, it's all
they
fuzzy.
They can't see it.
It's all fuzzy. That's why they start out with them cheaters.
It all starts after you hit 40. It's just most people are in denial until they hit about 46 or 47. Mm-hmm.
That's true. I think that's exactly right. Yeah.
So anyway, she was getting her first glasses.
I was in denial for a couple of years. And then I finally, you know what? I'm just going to quit putting off the inevitable. Yeah. And
I'm just tired of not being able to go into a store and tell what the price is or read the ingredients on something. I can't even see it. And I have to have somebody else to tell me what it is. But it was so cute. She was getting fitted for her glasses. And she looked down and she goes, oh my gosh, I can see this.
I said,
oh, that's so neat.
The first thing that popped through my mind when you said, I'm tired of going into a store and trying to read in the greens, and I'm picturing in my mind,
we don't have a cleanup on aisle two. We need somebody to look at ingredients on aisle two.
There's a blue light special in aisle three, and on aisle two, there's a lady that needs you to read the ingredients.
Ingredients. Yeah, they need to hire stores that will be like proofreaders, like label readers or something.
Half the time I'd be saying, oh, can you help me? Can you tell me how much this is? Or can you read this for me?
And they look at her like, what?
Yeah. What's wrong? You
can't
need
you
glasses,
you have any
lady?
Glasses with me.
Yeah, there you go.
It's bad. So, boy, next week I'm going to be...
You'll be looking different.
New world.
Kelley would go to a store, and she'd go to that little display that's got all the cheap readers.
Sure.
Put them on so she can read, and then she'd take them back off and put them back on
no.
the
rack. Kelley would buy them. I probably got about 50 cheaters around the house somewhere. And every time you go to need them, you don't have them.
Well, you know what? They fall within the category you're probably sleeping wrong, because you sleep with your contact lenses in or wearing your glasses at night.
Nope.
You don't.
When I have my cheap cheaters, I put them on the nightstand before I go to bed.
Okay. Not with your cheaters, glasses, even contact lenses. You need to... remove them before you go to bed.
And I'm going to take good care of my glasses. I'm going to lay them right beside my bed. What are you doing? He's checking out
I'm checking out your...
Yeah, look how dirty they are.
I'm checking out your cheapers.
Cheapers?
Your cheaper cheaters.
He's doing in the... what was it? I can't even think of what I'm... You're doing an experiment. Not an experiment. Investigate. You're doing an investigation.
I'm checking it out. That's
there
right.
You go.
You know, they look pretty good.
And I will tell you my findings later.
Yes. He will tell you. He's got something to tell you in a little bit.
Okay.
Maybe you're sleeping in the wrong position when you sleep. Do you sleep on your back? Do you sleep on your side? Do you sleep curled up in a ball? You know, that's another thing. Maybe you're sleeping wrong, in the wrong position.
You know, I wonder, it would be interesting to ask everybody what position they sleep in at night.
How do they know if they're asleep?
Well, you wake up and you're in that position.
Yeah, but that doesn't necessarily mean that's how you've been all night.
No, that is true.
I mean, it's just like people that snore. How do you know you snore if you're asleep?
Unless someone records it for you. Snoring.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's really the only proof is if somebody records it.
Someone has recorded me snoring before because I was in denial of snoring. And now, one day, guess who? My lovely bride.
Is her initials SW?
Yeah, my lovely bride. She says, here's proof you're snoring, and hits her recorder on her phone. And
oh, yes.
I'm like, okay.
Me too.
Guilty.
And isn't it awful?
It's terrible.
To hear that
think,
oh, my goodness, that came from me.
That's from me? But that's only when I'm really extremely tired.
Yeah, really tired makes it bad.
Yeah. Hey, here's another reason why you may be sleeping wrong. You never replace your pillows.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah.
Now, I've replaced mine.
Listen to this. You know dead skin that can double the weight of your pillow in 3 years?
That's a lot of dead skin you're losing.
That's what it says here. Yeah.
So how's the dead skin getting on the pillow if you have a pillowcase and if you take it off every week so or often? Every other week to wash it?
Well, yeah, yeah. Yeah, maybe they're talking about pillows that doesn't need a pillowcase or something.
Yeah. I can't imagine a pillow without a
pillowcase.
Exactly. No. They recommend you replace them about every 2 years, your pillows.
No, nobody does that because they get attached to it. Mm-hmm. A lot of people have had the same pillow since they were little.
Sure. Yeah.
It's kind of like that security blanket that Linus
yes.
from Peanuts.
From Peanuts. Hey,
yes.
Right?
You're right.
Your sleep schedule is non-existent. Sleeping in on Saturday feels refreshing at time, but it can sabotage the rest of your week. So they basically say you need to get up, stick to 7 to 8 hours of sleep, even on a weekend. And they say get up and get your day started. Don't sleep in.
Sleeping in is like getting up at 7:30 mm-hmm. now.
Yeah.
I used to sleep in until like 10, but I don't get to do that anymore.
And, you know, think of the people that work nights. They have weird sleep habits.
I could never do that.
It's not bad once you get used to it.
Well, that's the thing. I used to work a job where
I
never got used to it because it was just it changed so much.
All the time.
Well, you know, I'll give you another tip here in a moment. You sleep with your phone. That's why they say if you can't seem to separate from your phone even at night, you might want to try a little harder.
See, my phone stays in the other room.
Yep. They say don't rely on your phone. And we were talking about sleeping during the day. Your room isn't pitch black. Your circadian rhythm is ruled in part by lightness and darkness, so even the smallest slit of light can throw it off kilter. Yeah, make sure. You can buy now darkened curtains, black curtains, and, cover up your windows. It'll make them darker.
I like a little bit of light. I have a couple of light-up trees in my room.
Do you really?
Because I like to have a little bit of light.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She's scared of the dark. Yeah.
There you go.
She's scared of the dark.
She's scared the boogeyman's going to get her.
I got my watchdogs in the garage. They aren't going to get me. But I have to see the path to the bathroom.
Yeah. Now, here's one. Ladies, you sleep with your makeup on.
No, that's a no-no. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, they say, the thing to do, leaving makeup on overnight can clog pores and oil glands, which can stretch them out and make them appear larger. Skipping face wash can also cause inflammation, another aging risk. So wash your face, ladies.
And your pillowcase is a mess if you don't take it off.
Oh, yeah. Let's see.
Or your spouse is a mess because you snuggled up to him.
Yeah. Hey, did you put makeup on last night? No, that's you, I guess, rubbed against my face. Now, here's one. You fall asleep with the TV on.
We do it every night. We do.
We do the same thing.
But we set the sleep timer.
Yeah.
We used to do that.
Yeah. You fall asleep with the TV on. And, we do too. I mean, you got to have that,
Yeah. A lot of people do.
You snooze too long is another one. Like, for instance, get up when that alarm goes off. Don't hit the snooze button.
Oh, I did that this morning. I snoozed for 30 more minutes, and it was great.
To me,
it depends on how long that snooze is.
Could be.
Like, my alarm clock, that snooze is like 4 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Jennifer's alarm, it's 9 minutes.
Wow.
So I tend to do it longer on mine than I would if I was using her alarm clock.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Finally, now here's one, and I don't think what we think of this. Smell can play a role in a good sleep.
Well, yeah, because if you got something cooking in the kitchen overnight in the crock pot, you can smell that.
Mm-hmm. But that's not the kind of smell we're talking about. We're talking about lavender has been shown.
Kind of smell.
Yeah, that kind of smell.
that bothers me when I smell cooking.
Hey, Kelly, get up and put a roast on so I can sleep better.
Yeah.
There you go, Dennis.
No, that doesn't mean sleeping better. It detracts your sleeping.
Sure. Lavender decreases heart rate and blood pressure. It's
now
been
I'm all
shown
about
to do
the
that.
Lavender oil at night. Yes.
Yeah. One study even found that sleepers who sniffed lavender before drifting off slept deeper and felt more vigorous in the morning.
Yep.
That's according to the National Sleep Foundation.
So I like to spray it on my pillow, and then some people rubs it on their feet or on their neck or under their nose.
I can't stand anything rub. I was sick when, and Sherry is, she believes in the oils.
Yes.
All right. And I was sick. I had a cold, and just I was just really having trouble sleeping. Why? She says, lay down. She said, put your pajamas on, lay down, and stick your feet out under the covers. She started rubbing my feet. I can't stand that. It tickles.
Oh.
But you know what?
It worked.
It worked. The next morning, I got up and thought.
What did she put on, lavender, or did she put some kind of?
I can't remember what she put
Vicks
on. She's put Vicks on. She's put Vicks. She's rubbed all kinds of things on my feet. Maybe vegetable oil. I have no clue.
I've got a medicated salve that the Mennonites and Amish make. It's called Unkers.
Unkers.
And my grandparents. Got me hooked. Not hooked. I'm not hooked on it, but I mean they
really
used
works.
It, and it. I mean, it says. I mean, it works for anything, and it says that if you have a cold and congestion, not only do you rub it around your neck,
your
chest, but rub it on the soles of your feet and put socks on.
Yep.
And sleep
socks.
Like that,
and it works.
And it does. It does work.
Well, I ended up putting socks on, and afterwards, because you know, but I'm sitting there laughing. I can't stand it.
Tickle, 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 tickle.
Like, you know, but I just grinning and just, you know, laughing and but it worked. You know, if you can get by with, if you can stand it, it's good to put that on your feet.
Yep. It works.
But make sure you wash your feet off the next morning.
Yes.
Closes the pores. You know, I can remember being a young child, my mom. You know, when I had a chest cold and everything, she put Vicks on the chest.
Yep.
Then you go to bed and you get up the next morning. The main thing was make sure you wash your chest, wash it off with soap and water, dry it off, and then put baby powder on it.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And it helped close the pores. That was an old remedy she had. So I don't know if anybody else had a chance to do that, you know. But anyway, that's what they say anyway. All right. Hey, we're going to come back. Yeah, we're going to come back, and we have more ways to keep your dog healthy coming up. A lot more to look at the Friday Riddle and the TV show theme song on the way, guys. All right, sound
good? Good.
All right, it's the Vine Morning Show. It's Mark, Kelley, and Jimmy. We'll come back in a little bit, but right now it's time for A Moment in God's Word with Max Hooper. And this morning it's being underwritten by Crawford Plumbing and Woodlawn.
Crawford Plumbing, LLC in Woodlawn is licensed, bonded, insured, and ready to serve your household and business plumbing needs. From leaky faucets to complete plumbing systems and repair, Crawford Plumbing and Woodlawn is a full-service plumbing company. They can be reached at 618-242-3360. Crawford Plumbing in Woodlawn is a proud underwriting sponsor of Real Life Radio.
It's time now for A Moment in God's Word with your host, Max Hooper.
Hello, everyone. Okay, here's the battle line drawn in the sand for today. What will it be, the desires of the flesh, that's also known as the urge to sin, or will it be God's will that we will follow? Guess we should get a few definitions on the board before we go any further. Let's see, for the flesh side, we have, worship other gods, such as money, position, fame. And while you're doing these things, be sure to bow down to your money every day. Don't worry about how you use the Lord's name. Nothing will come of that. Pay no attention to the Sabbath. Go right ahead and do the things that you do any day. Above all, pay no attention to your mother or father. They're old and have no idea what's going on today. Murder? Well, that seems a good way to settle an argument. Pay no attention to that marriage agreement. And if you see something you want, well, just take it. And telling the truth is just for fools. Well, that's the flesh side. For Apostle Paul, further explanation, go to Galatians 5:19 and 21. That'll open your eyes. Will you see any problems that would arise from following all those desires? I do. We know that the will of God is the desire of every Christian. He has given us a roadmap to follow, and it is printed in the Bible. Every Christian knows that God will take the initiative to come to His people. Without God, can you imagine what it would be like? Without His word or His response to our prayers, we would be following those things listed above as the desires of the flesh. Turn away from His word leaves a big hole in our life and a vacuum that will be filled very quickly by the devil. We would all go around doing our own thing, stumbling in the darkness. We learned very early in our reading of God's Word that we are all very weak and defenseless. It tells us in Romans 3, verses 10 through 12, it says, "As it is written, there is no one righteous, not even one. There is no one who understands, no one who seeks God. All have turned away. They have together become worthless. There is no one who does good, not even one." It is true that all people turn away from God. That's just the nature of us all. Why is that? Should God not have made man perfect and given him the power to follow his word? Think of yourself. Have you not sinned? Have you followed his word? We are weak and above everything else need the power of God and his love, the forgiveness of God. Believe it or not, we cannot do it alone. God again tells us in Ecclesiastes 7:20, "There is not a righteous man on earth who does what is right and never sins." Without God and his love, we all will be in the pit with the sinners. Accept the fact that we are not strong enough to live a godly life without him. Step forward and accept Jesus and follow his path today and always. Thanks for being with us. This is Max Hooper. Have a great day.
You've been listening to A Moment in God's Word, a daily devotion hosted by Southern Illinois sports legend Max Hooper.
Does your church stream or archive their weekly worship services on the web? Have you thought about streaming your ministry but just don't know how? Here at Real Life Radio, we can help your church or other ministry stream to a worldwide audience with video or audio, as well as provide instant archiving, all at an affordable price that's lower than anyone in the area. There's also no limit on the size of your audience or the number of archives you have. Take your ministry worldwide. Find out more by visiting our website at wvyn.org.
Underwriting on the Vine is provided by Embroidery and More in Fairfield. Embroidery and More specializes in custom embroidery, custom heat transfers for your reunion, school, and church groups, as well as baby items, wedding gifts, and Americana decor. Their hours are 9 to 5 Monday through Friday, Saturdays 9 to 1. You can also like them on Facebook. Embroidery and More is located at 107 Southeast 2nd Street in Fairfield, and their phone number is 847-5027.
This is Pastor Ernie Lewis of the Blue Point Free Will Baptist Church, just north and west of Sisney. We'd like to invite you to come out to our services. We have Sunday school for all ages at 9:30 on Sunday morning, a morning worship service at 10:30, and a Sunday evening service at 6. Our youth service is Sunday night with all the teenagers at 6 o'clock. And on Wednesday night, now we've started some youth activities called SWAG, Serving and Worshiping an Awesome God. Our teenagers meet at 6:30 for supper, and then they have their Bible study afterwards, along with children. We have several children involved in this program, too. And then our adults meet for Bible study on Wednesday night at 7. We'd like to invite everyone to join us. If you're looking for God, he meets with us each and every time we get together. So come see us. Join us at Blue Point Church.
The following is a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off, so I made the call.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-606-4260.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-606-4260.
Time now for Hey Howard, the one-minute feature, underwritten by Fairfield Banking Company.
Hi, this is Ashley DeVoy with the Fairfield Banking Company. We've been strongly rooted in this area since 1892. Our foundation is strong, and we offer a unique checking account for customers 50 and older. It's called the 1892 Founders Club Checking, and it puts your money to work with interest paid on balances of $1,000 or more. You've worked hard to build a strong financial foundation for yourself, and now it's time to reap the rewards, including free checks and paper statements. Learn more about the 1892 Founders Club Checking account available at the Fairfield Banking Company, 915 Commerce Drive, member FDIC, and equal housing lender.
Helping you to be money smart, here's financial teacher Howard Dayton with today's question. Hey Howard, what's your opinion on investing in older classic cars, or for that matter, all collectibles?
Well, I wouldn't invest more than a very small percentage, say 5 to 10% of your investable dollars in classic cars or any type of collectibles, from stamps to baseball cards, you name it. The only time I'd do more if it was actually my business. Think of classic cars and collectibles more as a hobby than an investment, in part because, you know, if we experience a challenging financial time in our country, there won't be much of a market for classic cars or any other type of collectibles at that point. Now, here's what's really important. You need to learn God's way of investing, and you can do that just by visiting compassone.org. compassone.org.
Good morning, everyone. Time now to check sports for you on this Friday morning. Well, high school football for this season, regular season, wraps up tonight with a lot of high school games going on in the area. As Johnston City will be in Fairfield tonight, Carmine White County at Cesar Valier. Mount Vernon Rams will take on and tackle the Mount Carmel Aces in Mount Carmel tonight. Centralia will be at Muscoota. El Dorado will be at Chester. Edwards County at Hamilton County. Christopher Ziegler-Ralton will be at Vianna-Gorville. That game will be Saturday at 1 p.m. Also, Freeburg at Salem, Breeze Central at Heron, Pinckneyville will be at DuPo, Trenton Westland at Carlisle, Redbud at Sparta, Jerseyville at Columbia, Alnio at Casey Westfield, Marshall at Lawrenceville, Red Hill at Flora. Paris will be at Newton, Olympia at Robinson. That'll be Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock. Triad at Belleville-Altoff, Waterloo at Mater Dei, Greenville at Vandalia, Pena at Hillsboro, Litchfield at Carlinville, Southwestern at Roxana. Staunton will be at Gillespie. It will be Carbondale at Harrisburg, Crete Monet at Cahokia, Nashville at West Frankfort, DuCoin at Murfreesboro, Massac County at Carterville. And at Jonesboro will be at Benton, East St. Louis will be in O'Fallon, Belleville East to Collinsville, Alton at Belleville West, Granite City at Edwardsville, Marion at Mattoon, Muhammad Seymour at Effingham, Charleston at Highland, and Civic Memorial in Taylorville, at Taylorville tonight. Those are high school football games wrapping up the regular season tonight. High school volleyball action last night. Thompsonville beat Wayne City 2-0. Fairfield a winner over Sisney 2-0. Junior high girls basketball. New Hope beat Sisney 38-22. Now the junior high Jasper shootout going on. The girls game last night. Bluford beat Mount Carmel St. Mary's 39-32. It was New Hope boys beating Mount Carmel St. Mary's 43-11. In the girls' game last night, it was Alney St. Joe over Wayne City 36-9. And the boys' game, Alney St. Joe over West Salem 33-27. That's in the Jasper shootout. Now on the schedule for today, the Jasper shootout, 4:45 this afternoon. In the girls' game, it'll be Sisney and Jasper at 6 o'clock tonight. The boys' game, it'll be Sisney taking on Wayne City. And at 7:15 tonight, the boys' game will be Albion and Flora. And at 8:30, the girls' game will have Alney taking on Flora. College volleyball, the Hampton Inn Volleyball Classic at Lincoln College will kick off today. At 3 o'clock, Lincoln will take on Southeastern Community College. At 5 p.m., Highland Community College taking on the Frontier Lady Bobcats. And DuPage at Southeastern will take on Southeastern at that Hampton Classic at Lincoln College, also at 5. At 7, it'll be Lincoln taking on Frontier Lady Bobcats and DuPage taking on Highland. That's in college volleyball, the Hampton Inn Volleyball Classic at Lincoln College. Major League Baseball action from Thursday. Well, the Chicago Cubs are one game away from advancing to the World Series. Now, last night, the Cubs beat the Dodgers in Los Angeles 8-4. Now the Cubs lead that series 3-2. And now the scene shifts back to Wrigley Field on Saturday, tomorrow night at 7:08, as the Dodgers will make that trek back to Chicago, take on the Cubs at Wrigley Field tomorrow night. Now the winner between the Dodgers and the Cubs will take on Cleveland in the World Series beginning on Tuesday in Cleveland. NFL football action, Thursday night football. Green Bay Packers, they beat the Bears last night by the score of 26-10. NCAA football, there were a couple of games, actually three games last night. Virginia Tech over Miami 37-16, Troy over South Alabama 28-21, And Boise State defeated BYU. Boise State ranked number 14 in the country over BYU, 28-27, the final score there. NBA preseason basketball. It was Orlando beating New Orleans in overtime, 114-111. Charlotte over Miami, 96-88. New York beat Brooklyn, 116-111. And Atlanta beat Chicago, 97-81. National Hockey League scores. From last night, Edmonton beat the Blues 3-1. Boston over New Jersey by the score of 2-1. It was Anaheim beating Philadelphia 3-2. Pittsburgh over San Jose 3-2. Montreal over Arizona 5-2. Colorado beat Tampa Bay 4-0. It was Washington 4, Florida 2. Minnesota over Toronto 3-2 in overtime. Los Angeles beat Dallas 4-3. Carolina over Calgary 4-2. And Vancouver winner over Buffalo 2-1. Don't forget the Sports Couch coming up for you tomorrow morning at 8:30 here on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, as Danny and Randy will be in the studio talking about tonight's high school football games and talking with some area coaches. It's 90 minutes worth of sports talk. The Sports Couch coming up Saturday morning at 8:30 from 8:30 to 10 here on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That's Check Sports for you on this Friday morning. I'm Mark Wells reporting.
What do you do on Wednesday nights? Here at Orchardville Church, we have a lot going on. We have something for all ages. We have nurseries, pre-K through fifth grade, an awesome youth group, which includes junior and senior high ages. And for the adults, we have music, praying, teachings, and testimonies of what God has done. Come and get a midweek boost. You'll be glad you did. Services begin at 7 p.m. Like us on Facebook or visit us at orchardvillechurch.com.
How great is God's amazing grace.
Time now to check the area weather forecast, and this morning it's being underwritten by Home Source Warehouse in Mount Vernon.
Monthly financial support of local Christian radio is provided by Home Source Warehouse in Mount Vernon. Located 4 miles north of Mount Vernon on Route 37, Home Source Warehouse offers a warehouse full of quality furniture and mattresses with legendary service. Open Thursday and Friday 10 to 6, Saturday 10 to 3. You can find them on Facebook, and their website is homesourcewarehouse.net. Their phone number is 204-5515. Home Source Warehouse, where style is affordable.
Southern Illinois weather.
Well, a beautiful weekend indeed. Clear skies all the way through Monday. The high temperature today, clear and sunny, all 4 days. 59 today, 65 the high tomorrow, 75 on Sunday. And then Monday, high of 68. Right now in the area, Benton 45, Fairfield 46, McLeansboro 47, Flora 46, Mount Vernon 45. And in Wayne City right now, 47. They'll be in Effingham on Thursday, November the 3rd. The Prodigal Tour, here's Sidewalk Prophets. And Prodigal coming up next right here at The Vine. Thursday, November 3rd, 7 o'clock, the Effingham Performance Center. The Prodigal Tour will roll into the Effingham Performance Tour, Performance Center. Their tour will be the same tour that was at Little Chapel Church in Harrisburg here a few weeks back. An evening with Sidewalk Prophets. You can go to our website, wbyn.org, and order tickets for that concert. Again, that's on Thursday, November 3rd, the Effingham Performance Center, the Prodigal Tour, guys. Again, if you didn't make it, what an awesome night that was.
Kelley didn't.
Yeah.
Nope.
Yeah.
I wasn't there, and I can't remember why.
Yeah.
There was some reason why.
She backed out at the last minute.
Was it detailing or?
I don't remember what was going on that night. He thinks I don't do anything.
She doesn't.
Yeah.
She sat in the car yesterday. She admitted it.
I was doing business on the phone, things that I don't get to do because I'm always so busy.
When you drove by, you saw her in the car.
I saw you everywhere.
She was probably hiding something in the trunk.
Oh, could have been doing one of those.
Let me tell you now, that trunk was so big, you could fit about 10 people in the back of that trunk. It's one of them older cars, and I'm telling
A 74
had a trunk.
Like a land yacht?
Yes.
Like a land yacht.
I told Dennis, I said, you're going to have to be the one bend down and get down in there. I've done all I can reach to get.
You couldn't reach any further. Huh?
No, you literally have to get in it to vacuum it. It's so big.
Really?
Yeah.
Have to get in. So it basically is a land yacht.
It's huge.
It was huge. Huge car, like a 74 Mercury Marquis or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah.
Have you guys ever been to Judgment House, to a Judgment House before?
No.
You never
have,
Jimmy?
I haven't either.
Oh, my goodness.
And I'm looking forward to this.
Well, Orchardville Church is getting ready to have Judgment House this year. And the first one will be tonight and then next Friday, October 28th from 7 to 10 p.m.
Yep.
Then Saturday, October 22nd, which is tomorrow, and then next Saturday, the 29th, from 6 to 10 p.m., and then Sunday, October 30th, from 4 to 7 p.m., Judgment House.
Yes, I'm looking forward to
this. Oh, yeah, check it out. If you have an opportunity to go, it'll change your life. Very powerful, all right? And if you want more information, call the Orchardville Church, 835-2677. You can visit ochurch.com. Now, tickets at ochurch.com, and I'm sure they'll have tickets available at the door tonight.
And they are free, right? Or is it a fundraiser?
Because
the information that I've seen has said nothing about there being a cost for it or what. So
I'm not sure. It doesn't list here on the list here. So
that's what I'm saying. The information I've seen.
I guess we
could go to ochurch.com and
check
find
that out.
Out.
Check that out on your little computer there, Jimmy, if you don't mind. All
Let's
right.
See.
Well, while you're doing that, and while you're checking that out. You know, we were talking earlier this morning about ways to keep your dog healthy, right? And, you know, dogs do get ear infections like us humans.
They do.
Mm-hmm.
Aren't you supposed to keep the water out of their ears?
Oh, yeah, when you give them a bath. Yeah, it's very important. Do you know Johnson's baby oil works good? To keep, if you have too much water in your dog's ears, can lead to painful earaches, just like in us. So before you give him or her a bath, place a cotton ball moistened with Johnson's baby oil in each of your pet's ears to keep the water out. Just be sure to remove the cotton balls afterwards.
Oh, yeah, don't forget.
yeah, don't forget that. Yeah, very important. You know, dogs get dandruff. You know that?
No.
Yeah. You can stop dandruff with the Bear Aspirin and Johnson's Baby Shampoo.
Now, never heard of that.
Yeah. Now, unless you're allergic to aspirin, some people are, grind 6 Bear Aspirin to a fine powder using a mortar and pestle. Pour in the pulverized aspirin into a bottle of Johnson's Baby Shampoo and shake well. Lather up your dog with the shampoo. Let it sit for about 5 minutes to allow the acid in the aspirin time to exfoliate your pet's dead skin cells. Rinse clean with water.
Okay.
Yeah. And does your dog dig when they go out?
Yes.
Yes, yeah. You know, dogs, that's just their habit. They want to dig.
Yep.
But to discourage digging, here's what you do. Tabasco, pepper sauce, and McCormick ground cayenne red pepper.
Oh,
yeah.
Boy.
Yeah. Now, if your dog goes out in the yard and likes to dig, mix 4 tablespoons of pepper sauce and 4 tablespoons of cayenne pepper into 1 quart of water. Sprinkle the spicy solution over the area where your dog digs. No more digging.
No more digging.
Well, that'd be a lot of stuff because... What if your dog has a whole big yard to go,
yard.
Different spots to go to?
True, very true. Let's see. Olive oil is good for getting out chewing gum. Now, if your dog gets bubble gum stuck to his paw or fur, saturate the gum with oil, rub your fingers to soften it, and comb it out. Shampoo and rinse. It's very good to do that.
Hmm.
Yeah. Now, you know, dogs get arthritis just like we do.
Yes, they do.
And a sock filled with rice. To soothe arthritis pain, fill a sock with uncooked white rice. Tie a knot in the end and heat in the microwave for 1 minute. Then place it right over their joints twice a day for about 15 minutes. So there you go. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Bag balm. You guys heard of bag balm before, right?
Yes.
It helps heal cuts and scrapes. Epsom salts relieve itchy paws. So there you go. Ways to keep your dog healthy.
Well,
interesting.
Interesting tips there.
You like those, huh?
Yeah. I did not know dogs could have dandruff, though.
Yeah, they can. They can have dandruff. And dandruff. That's right. Yeah.
Hmm.
Hey, Jimmy, did you find anything out on...
I did. Nowhere do I see anything about a price, and nowhere do I see where it says that it's free. Mm-hmm. So because I don't see a price or a cost or anything, I'm going to assume that it is free. And they have right now tickets available for every, I think they have a guided tour every 10 minutes is what it is.
Okay.
And they have a guided tour that is still available for tonight at 8:10 p.m. 9:30, 9:40, and 9:50. Everything else is booked in full.
Wow.
Yeah. You know what? That's what I say. They sell out in a hurry. And I would not be surprised, and this is just my prediction, and these have happened before, they'll extend it.
Yeah.
You know, that by if it's that high in demand, you know, they may extend it. Just keep listening and just keep checking out their website.
You think it only takes like 10 minutes to go through?
Well, not necessarily 10 minutes to go through, but that once you get 10 minutes in, they can go ahead and start the next group go through. I don't know how long it's going to take to go through.
Yeah, we don't know. So I think you just pace yourself and, you know, we'll see.
And but it's anyway. A guided tour, so the tour guide that's with you is going to know, okay, we need to start moving things along. We need to start moving things, or the next group's going to catch up.
Right. Okay.
That's my guess.
Sure. So, yeah, check out ochurch.com for more information, too, as well. Or give them a call. Give the church a call.
I'm looking forward to going to this.
Yeah, their number 835-2677. All right, you guys want to do the TV show theme song this morning at 895-3030. We'll have you call in a moment. We're going to play that team thong. team song for
cute.
You.
You couldn't do that even if you tried.
I'll play it again. Yeah, the theme song for you. Here in just a few moments.
That's so funny.
Hey, we're going to give away. We have Ray's Dog House gift certificate, guys, that we'll be giving away as well. And for those of you watching at home, there is a look at Ray's Dog House gift certificate. Also, we have a Water Wash coupon that we give away. Also, a Citizens Way CD for our prizes.
Nice.
And a God's Not Dead Bible book cover that we give away this morning. So you guys, and also we can't forget this. Country Bob's barbecue sauce.
Oh, yes, the all-purpose sauce.
From our friends at Country Bob's in Centralia. So I'll let you guys pick the prize. What do you want to give away today, guys?
Well, we're going to do
you
car
pick
wash.
It, Kelley. I picked last week.
All right.
We're going to do the Water Wash Car Wash coupon.
Let's do... Boy, this is tough.
It's tough.
Okay. Not really. Can you see them?
Yeah.
Can you see which one?
You're funny.
Yeah.
All right, give me the music.
And we're going to do the Citizen Way CD as well. We're going to do that one this morning.
And he just wants to model. Mm-hmm. And, let's do this, the all-purpose sauce.
The all-purpose sauce from Country Bob's.
That's what I was thinking, too.
Ooh!
All right, so there you go. The Citizen Way CD, all-purpose sauce, and Water Wash Car Wash.
Yes.
Coupon this morning as your prizes here on Funday Friday here on the Vine Morning Show. All right. So there you go. 895-3030 is our phone number to call. And do you want me to give the clues again, or you just want to play the
just play
song,
it? All right? You're going to know it now when he plays this song.
Yeah. What's the other clue that you were going to give?
The other clue because
we're getting ready to give it away anyway. Yeah. So
aired on CBS from 1968 to 1980.
I'd like one more clue before I hear the theme song. Personally.
You want one more? Someone's going to get it. Okay. You want me to give the other clue? I gave the group Ventures.
Yeah, that did nothing for me.
Jack Lord.
I knew that one was coming next.
Yeah. Yeah, that still doesn't help you. Now, don't call in yet. We want to play the song for you. So stay tuned. So stay tuned. I've got a frog in my throat. That I, when I try to clear my throat, here we go.
You're making this so fun.
I can't wait to go back and watch the archive of this on the website.
I might have to have another drink of water here. Anyway, the song we're going to play for you here in a moment. All right. 89533. You guys ready for this?
Yes, all right. I am.
All right, here we go. And someone's going to get it. We know they will. So here is today's TV show theme song. That's just part
of it.
You
know it. You know that.
That's just part of it. Here, I'll play another part of it for you.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know what it is now.
There you go.
Yeah, I know what it is now.
You know what it is. 8-9-5-30-30. Do you know, do you listeners know our TV show theme song?
I can't even do motions because of the video.
Yeah, of the video. Yeah. Let me play a little more for you. All right, let's see. Let me see. Did I play this one already? Yeah, we played that one. Let's try this one. Yeah. Hey, it aired on CBS from 1968 to 1980.
And it has a really cool drum solo at the beginning.
Yes, it does. Yeah. It does. And by the way, the series premiered in the United States on September 20th, 2010, exactly 42 years after the premiere of the original series.
So the original was 12 years?
Yeah.
I did not realize that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So if you know our TV show theme song this morning, call us up at 895-3030. We're going to give you all these cool prizes. That you can have a chance at winning here this morning from the Vine Morning Show, 895-3030. Someone is calling us up, guys. So
good.
Let's see if we have a winner this morning and find out who our caller is. Good morning, caller. Who's this?
Hey, this is Deborah Gresham from Bloomsburg.
Hey, Deborah. How are you this morning?
Well, how are you?
Hey, I'm fine. Thank you.
Good. We haven't heard from you in a little while. How have you been?
I know. Fine. Good. I listen to y'all all the time, though.
Good.
Yeah, well, we appreciate that, Deborah. All right. Hey, thanks for calling in this morning, and we've got some cool prizes to give to you this morning. If you can identify our TV show theme song this morning that we're talking about. What do you think that TV show theme song is, Deborah?
Is it Hawaii Five-0?
You know what?
That
you
is
are
it.
All right. It is yes. Hawaii Five. Did you like that show,
Yay.
Deborah?
Oh yeah, it was fine.
Now, do you watch the new version that's on TV now?
No, I don't.
You don't.
It's not near as good as the old one.
The old one is the best. I mean, you know, you had Jack Lord, who was Steve McGarrett,
and
Wofat
was
his nemesis.
Now, see, the only clue that would have made definitely without hearing it that I thought of,
mm-hmm.
Bookum Dano, he's 5-0.
Yes, that's what I was. I thought that might be a clue, but that really would have given him away.
Sure. And, of course, Steve McGarrett, he drove that 1974 Mercury Marquis.
Steve McGarrett.
Yeah, and actually that car belonged to a stuntman by the name of John Nordlum. And so he's letting the car be used again in the new series. They went and asked him.
Nice.
So, Deborah, congratulations. You just won these cool prizes. Just stay on the line with me. I'll come back in a moment and get some details from you, okay?
Okay. Thank you very much.
All right. Bye, Deborah. Right. Have a great weekend.
All right.
Thanks. You too. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Hey, that's Deborah, our friend Deborah from Bloomsburg, who wins. All right. She guessed today's TV show theme song. Good for her today.
Yes. She got a nice little prize pack
there.
Bookum Dano.
Bookum Dano. Yes,
I almost said that while ago to you, and I thought, nope, that'll give it away.
So Hawaii
that definitely
5-0.
Would have given it away for me because that's the one thing that I do remember about Hawaii 5-0.
Yeah, and the group Ventures wrote the theme song.
I didn't know that.
Hawaii 5-0 theme song. And
that's what I've been wanting to bust out all morning. It's just a good song.
Yep, they wrote the theme song. So congratulations, Hawaii 5-0, today's movie, our TV show theme song. Now next week we'll do a movie theme song, all right?
Next week
we'll do that, all right? Hey, more to come. We've got the Friday Riddle, and we have some more cool prizes to give away on this Funday Friday as it's Mark, Kelley, and Jimmy right here on the Vine Morning Show. As we're heading into the 9 o'clock hour, more to come. Stay tuned. Here's Chris Habermel and Galaxies. He's next right here at the Vine.
all free through your cross. Your blood redefined us, we are the sons and the daughters of God. Your grace runs deep from the world to the moon to the sun. Love is one.
This is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
The best Christian music, 90.9 The Vine.
old times sing when I win. I can sing when I lose my step and I fall down again. I can sing 'cause you pick me up. Sing 'cause you're there.
Music and ministry that is always uplifting and encouraging. Local Christian Radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. How can I keep from singing? Chris Tomlin. It is time right now for Uncommon Moments with Tony Dungy and his wife Lauren Dungy this morning, underwritten by Fairfield National Bank.
As a financial advisor, John Reynolds is well-versed in the best practices of financial planning. But as a local, raised in Wayne County, he's more than experienced with the unique challenges you face every day. After growing up here, he's now returned, investing back into the community that contributed to his success, passionate and committed to helping you with yours. FNB Asset Management. We're here to help.
This is Uncommon Moments with Super Bowl winning coach Tony Dungy and his wife Lauren on their uncommon marriage adventure. Available now in paperback.
All of our wisdom and all of our knowledge comes from one timely source, and that's the Bible. Genesis 2, verses 23 and 24 says, "At last," the man explained, "this one is bone from my bone and flesh from my flesh. She will be called woman because she was taken from a man." And this explains why a man leaves his father and his mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united as one. So an uncommon marriage is when a husband and wife have God at the center of their lives, and they look to the Bible to guide them.
The Uncommon Marriage Adventure by Tony and Lauren Dungy. Now available in softcover from Tyndale Momentum. More info at CoachDungy.com.
More music and ministry for Fairfield, Benton, and Mount Vernon.
90.9 The Vine.
Laws that once were etched in stone, back when Moses hid his face, led to death and led to glory. They know a time of righteousness. I'm a letter from you, Savior Lord. Your love's engraved upon my heart. All this old is finally ended. A new covenant, a new star. Every veil, give me your eyes to see, to walk in your spirit. Your truth is revealed. Your time on the cross, let salvation prevail. Hidden no more, remove every veil. Remove every veil.
door that turned to you for a new sense of freedom. Uncover grace I could not feel. What was once concealed, remove every veil. Give me your eyes to see, to walk in your spirit. Your truth is revealed. Your time on the cross, let salvation prevail. Eyes of your understanding, that I might live my life with the hope of your calling. The name above all names, mighty in power, I surrender, Lord, I am falling. Remove every veil, give me your eyes to see, to walk in your spirit. Your truth is revealed. Your time on the cross, let salvation prevail. Turn to the Lord, let the veil be taken away. Destroy in this mountain all that's not of God. Let blindness be taken away. Let the heart of all nations turn to the Lord, and the veil is taken away. Destroy in the mountain all that's not of God. Open my eyes, remove every veil. I pray, remove every veil.
Music and ministry that is always uplifting and encouraging. It's local Christian radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Jonathan Cain, his song Remove Every Veil. And we all know where he's from, guys.
Yeah, it's a great song.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah.
Love that song. Yeah,
keyboard player from Journey.
Journey, yeah. Isn't that amazing? Great song from him, Jonathan Cain, here on Real Life Radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Welcome you back to The Vine Morning Show. Funday Friday here. On this beautiful Friday, I'm Mark, along with Kelley and Jimmy. Hey, you know, there are some at-home remedies maybe you have heard of and maybe you haven't heard of before, guys.
Ooh, I'm looking forward to these.
Do you like home remedies?
I love home remedies.
Oh, yeah.
They
absolutely
usually work better than anything.
Than anything out there.
If mm-hmm. they're done properly.
Yes.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, if they're done properly. That's the key.
You yeah, said it. That is the key.
Now, when you think of hiccups, how do you think of the best way to get rid of them?
Well, everybody usually says,
hold your breath.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's another way you can do it.
A teaspoon of sugar.
You're right.
That helps the medicine go down.
Mm-hmm.
I know.
No, that's a spoonful of sugar.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's close.
And I'll get to that. But another way is, too, you take a gulp of water. You swallow water, but you don't swallow it. You hold it. Take both fingers and put in your ears. And then plug your ears and then swallow the water. At that point in time.
Okay, Kelley, get the hiccups real quick.
Yeah.
Go ahead, get the hiccups real quick. We want to see you do that.
Yeah, we need to try that. Yeah, we need to try that. So it does work.
I have been having it.
You know what else works?
Lately, though. Mm-hmm.
And my wife showed me about this. You say, okay, look at me. She'll go, look at me. Look at me. Now hiccup. And then it's like, you don't do it. And then she goes, oh, hey, do me again. Look at me again. Hiccup. And like, it's like all
like,
of a sudden.
Like scaring away. You or yeah. something. Huh, never heard of that one before.
Well, I can't imagine swallowing a teaspoon of sugar.
Well, it does. It can help stop hiccups. The dry the granules of sugar stimulate and reset the irritated nerve that is causing the spasms of the diaphragm.
I think it would just make me cough.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, you don't take it as you're hiccuping.
Yeah, yeah. You just get the hiccup.
No, I mean dry. Mm-hmm. Something dry in your mouth and swallow something dry like that. Mm-hmm. And
yeah,
I think
yeah.
it'd make you cough.
Well, yeah, but it's the dry granules of that sugar help stimulate the nerves and everything.
Having problems. Yeah. I can't keep these on right today. Yeah,
you're not getting on right. There. It'll give you headset 101.
It's that hair clip.
Yeah,
the hair clip's throwing
the hair clip
it off.
In the middle. Yeah, I didn't know if our sign was holding it up or not for you.
Oh, now it's gouging me in the head.
Yeah, there it is. All right. Hey, something else, too, is good, but it's less palatable. Salt. It's another good option, but I.
It's that same
texture as sugar.
Yeah, yeah.
Just same sugar thing. Is sweeter.
Mm-hmm. I'd rather swallow a teaspoon of honey.
Yeah, well,
maybe
but
that
it doesn't
works.
Have that.
Yeah.
That texture.
I know.
Texture in it.
That's right.
So anyway, yeah, those swallowing sugar helps get rid of hiccups. Sipping echinacea root can also reduce the length of a cold and significantly reduce how often you catch it.
A root?
Sipping echinacea root.
That's easy for you to say.
Yeah, yeah. It's like tea.
Echinacea?
Yeah, it's like tea. Yeah, echinacea. Yeah, it's like hot tea.
Echinacea.
Yeah, echinacea root.
Sounds like a country.
Yeah, yeah, echinacea root. But, you know, hot tea is good, but echinacea root is good.
Okay.
Chicken noodle soup is good.
Yes.
Oh, yeah,
for the common
good.
Cold. It helps the warm liquids help speed up the movement of the mucus through the nose.
Oh, yeah, good old mucus.
Chicken noodle.
Any kind of broth.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, any broth. Now, here's one. Now, if your loved ones turn up their noses at the reek of your feet, it's time to take matters into your hands. Here's what you do. Removing I'm getting ready to laugh because of what this says here. Removing foot odor is surprisingly simple. You can either soak them 20 minutes in salt water bath every day for 2 weeks, or soak them in a solution of one part vinegar and two parts water every 30 minutes a day for a week. Salt water and vinegar soaking your feet.
That gets rid of the odor for life?
Yeah. Reek of your feet. It helps get rid of foot odor.
Reek of your feet.
Yes.
Soaking in vinegar.
Vinegar and salt water. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, you know, pregnant women swear by ginger ale for alleviating morning sickness. But something else is good. Steeping ginger. Like taking ginger is good for that. Let's see.
Boiling a ginger root?
Yeah, like ginger root, yeah. It helps with nausea. Yeah. 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 Let's see. What else? That's it. Yeah, some home remedies maybe you've never heard of before.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, so there you go.
I'm going to try the reek feet thing. Or
reeking of feet.
Reeking of feet.
Yeah, he has the issue once in a while. I'll have to get some vinegar and salt.
There's all kinds of home remedies out there. There's more than that, you know, but you just have to do your research on it.
Yeah,
but
I think there's a book of home remedies in there.
Yeah,
big book.
Oh,
yeah.
You know, the older generation, older than us, had some
That's
really
where
awesome.
All the key old, answers
yeah,
are.
Yeah, they are. The old, from the older generation.
It
My
is.
Mom used to have all kinds of home remedies. And boy, did they work. They really did. Here's one for ice cubes. Maybe you had no clue about how you can use ice cubes around your house. Pluck your eyebrows. Soothe plucked eyebrows. Yeah. Giving your eyebrows a good tweeze will make them look fabulous.
Freeze them first.
Yeah, you freeze them. That's right. Use an ice cube to ease the pain and any red inflammation before putting on makeup or going out.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's all right. Yeah. I'd rather have the pain of the plucking than the pain of the freezing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that'd be all right.
That hurts.
Water hanging plants and Christmas trees. Now think about this for a moment. If you're constantly reaching for the step stool to water hard-reached hanging plants, ice cubes can help. Just toss several cubes into the pots. The ice melts and water the plant.
There you go.
Good way to water your Christmas tree. If you, maybe hard that to reach the base with a watering can, just throw some ice cubes
That's
in
there. That's why we have one of those little tube things that goes down, and you don't have to bend down. You just pour it into there, and it goes down into the little
base.
Do you usually
base.
Do a live Christmas tree?
Yes, we do.
Mm-hmm.
This year we probably won't.
Why?
Just because we're not going to do a live tree this year. Mm-hmm.
This would be the first time?
Yeah. Yeah.
You can't stop breaking the tradition.
Well, we're in the process of getting ready to work on something to start making new traditions. So,
aww.
I mean, in order for you to begin new traditions, sometimes you have to stop doing a current tradition so you can start doing a new tradition.
Oh, okay.
Well,
I got
look
you.
At you.
So out with the old and with,
in
the,
with
new.
The new.
Well,
that's
all right. Then.
It's kind of like the psalm saying, sing a new song unto the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing wrong with the old songs. But sometimes you just got to sing a new song.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that neat? Yeah.
In
with the old.
That's going to be interesting.
There's a biblical lesson in whether or not you're going to do a real live Christmas tree.
Yeah. So, watering Christmas trees is good with ice cubes. Remove dents in carpeting. You guys, if you have carpet in your home and you're rearranging your living room furniture and you have dents.
Yeah.
What you do, you use ice cubes to remove them. Put an ice cube on the spot where the chair leg stood. Let it melt and brush up the dent. The
that
rug
makes sense.
Rehab is completed.
Well,
yeah,
that makes sense.
Yeah. You can prevent stains from setting. The common advice you hear is to dab some water the second you splatter something on yourself, but ice cubes work even more effectively. The next time you need to prevent a stain from setting, rub the spot as soon as it happens with an ice cube. Yeah.
Hmm.
And do you keep rubbing it until it's melted, what's the deal with that?
I guess until maybe it's soaked.
Yeah,
and then
probably
just
until it's
see,
soaked
yeah,
good.
See if what happens.
Then you can eat the ice cube.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. Kids. Now, for parents that have small children, mask the taste of medicine. Now, no matter what flavor your local pharmacy will give you on children's medicine, they will turn up the nose at the taste, right?
Mm-hmm.
So have them suck on an ice cube before taking the medicine. This numbs the taste buds and allows the medicine to go down without the spoonful of sugar.
They won't taste it.
They won't taste it.
Wow, that's a good idea.
Yes.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Huh.
Makes sense.
I like that one.
Yeah, you like that one?
Yeah.
All right. Pluck a splinter. Now, before removing a splinter from the hand of a screaming toddler or us, when we get splinters.
A screaming Mark?
Yeah.
Sherry numbs him first.
Yeah. Before you start jabbing with that needle, which I've dug him out many times with splinters, grab an ice cube and numb the area quickly. This
good
will make
idea.
The splinter removal more painless and quicker. Yes.
Especially if you have to dig to get to it.
Ugh.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, here's one. Say you got to put a dinner together real quick, and you want to make creamy salad dressing, and you just don't have the time to do all that. And, here's what you could do. You can put all the dressing ingredients in a jar with a lid, then add a single ice cube. Close the lid, shake very vigorously, spoon out the ice cube, and serve. Your guest will be impressed at how creamy your salad dressing is.
Oh,
yeah.
Interesting.
Isn't that cool?
Wow.
Yeah.
What's your definition of vigorously?
Really hard.
Yeah.
Really, really, really hard. As hard as you just
get
can shake it.
Get rough with it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, as hard as you can shake it.
I just wanted to see you do it on the video, on the video, on the camera.
There you go. Yeah, I thought there was an ulterior motive. All right. Hey, one more. Have you ever got, gum stuck on your clothing before? Many times?
Yep.
Yes.
Ice
cube.
Yeah. Maybe, to your pants or something. All you do, rub the ice on the gum to harden it, then scrape it off with a spoon.
Same way in the car. In the car.
It works wonders.
Yep.
Yeah. 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 It does work. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. Hey, you guys, let's move on, and then we're going to do our Friday Riddle in a moment.
Yes.
Have you ever played with a Rubik's Cube before?
Yeah, and I don't have patience for it.
Long time ago.
Just don't have the patience.
I know. They're so hard to do. Do you know there are 43 quintillion possible combinations? 43 quintillion possible combinations.
Huh.
Never heard of quintillion.
No. That's a lot of zeros. But yeah. There's, 43. Who had the time to figure that out, I wonder? 43 quintillion.
I don't know.
Yeah. At one time the yellow side was a health risk. When the Rubik's Cube made its way to England in 82, health officials discovered there was more of a risk than just going out of your mind trying to solve it. A plastic disc affixed to the squares were found to contain unsafe levels of lead.
Mm.
Yeah. They had to remake them. They had to remake the Rubik's Cube from that. Yeah. Someone solved it from falling from a plane. A guy by the name of Dan Knights decided to get a new perspective. 2003, he was a very big Rubik's Cube enthusiast. He jumped from a plane 12,000 feet, giving him roughly 45 seconds of free fall time to dissolve the dissolve the cube before his parachute would have to be opened. But what he did, get this, he drilled a hole in the cube and tied it to a loop on his wrist so it wouldn't fall. The jump was, which was commissioned by VH1, was successful. He solved it in 32 seconds.
Wow.
From 12,000 feet.
Can't even imagine that.
But wait, you haven't heard anything yet.
But wait, there's more.
There's more.
There's more than jumping out of a plane?
Yeah, there's more. Let me give you this one here. The world record for solving the Rubik's Cube with your hand. What do you think?
How fast?
Yeah, how fast?
10 seconds.
No, wait. 2 seconds.
A 14-year-old by the name of Lucas Etter, back in November 2015, he set a world record, 4.90 seconds.
Wow.
Yeah. But you don't necessarily need to use your hands. A guy by the name of Jakub Kipa, he can solve it in 20.5 seconds, 5.7 seconds, using only his feet.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. He can do that
in 20. Extremely talented years. People. Mm-hmm.
And some people can do it blindfolded.
How?
Yeah. A 7-year-old Chan Hong Leek from China solved one in 2016 by first memorizing the placement of the squares and then obscuring his vision so he can't see the cube in motion. Guess how long it took him to solve it? 2 minutes, 21 seconds.
Wow.
Isn't that amazing that he did that? You need to keep it oiled. Now, serious cubers know that a Rubik's Cube that hasn't officially been properly maintained is going to hamper their efforts. So, Rubik's website advises Cube Lube has some kind of plastic component. It has a silicone formulation in it. So you can get some Cube Lube if you are a serious cuber to keep it oiled.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
Interesting.
So anyway, facts about the Rubik's Cube this morning. Pretty cool,
wow.
Huh? Yeah, all right.
I guess I can't imagine people that... They're just gifted, I guess,
yeah,
to be able to do that, because I can't even solve it.
I could do one side.
You can?
Yeah, I could
make
do...
Make it all one
just
color?
Just do one side, make it all one color. But
yeah.
As far as after that, no.
No.
Unless I just peel them all, peel the stickers off. And
yeah, there you go.
There's got to be a trick.
There's got to be a trick. All right.
There has to be.
Hey, we're going to come back in a moment, guys, as Funday Friday on the Vine Morning Show continues in a moment. We'll have our Friday Riddle on the way, so stick around for that, all right? That's to come. All right, Mark, Jimmy, and Kelley coming back on the Vine Morning Show. Time now for Voice of the Martyrs, underwritten by the Tin Shed, and they're located in Wayne City. 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine is thankful for the underwriting support of the Tin Shed in Wayne City. They are your source for primitive, country, and home decor in a wide selection to meet your decorating needs. The Tin Shed is located at 701 West Robinson in Wayne City, and their phone number is 895-2155.
Hi, I'm Todd Nettleton, and this is Voice of the Martyrs Radio. When Miriam and Marzia came to faith in Jesus Christ, they began to boldly share their faith, even distributing Bibles on the streets of Tehran. Soon they were hosting 2 home Bible studies. Their daring witness drew the attention of Iranian authorities, and they were arrested and thrown into the notorious Evin prison. Yet even in prison, they proclaimed the gospel to their fellow inmates. Miriam and Marzia continue to share the hope of Jesus with Muslims today and have written a book titled Captive in Iran. Join me in praying for bold evangelists like Miriam and Marzia and for the people of Iran, that they would come to know Jesus Christ as their Savior.
I will not let my brothers and sisters suffer in silence, nor will I let them serve alone. To hear Miriam and Marzia share their story, go to vomradio.net.
The best Christian music, 90.9 The Vine.
Inside my mind, I try.
when did I forget that you've always been the king of the world? I try to take life back right out of the hands of the king of the world. How could I make you so small when you're
That is Natalie Grant from Real Life Radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. It is 9:35 and it's the Vine Morning Show. It's Funday Friday. I'm Mark along with Kelly and Jimmy. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, a beautiful day in Southern Illinois.
Oh,
today.
It's going to be a wonderful weekend, guys.
Yes, it's going to be a nice weekend. And a lot going on in the area. You can go to our Community and Christian Event calendar on our website and check out what events are going on in the area and take an advantage of it.
We're finally having a fall weekend weather-wise.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, it's supposed to be, well, let's see. Let me pull the weather up here real
quick.
Isn't
it like only low 60s in the day?
Yeah, well, and 59 today for the high.
And here's our disclaimer, because and I've been wanting to do this whenever I do the weather forecast on the afternoon show. We get this from our, the weather comes from our website. Now, the Lord has the right to change it.
That's right.
So don't hold us to it.
That's
okay?
right. That's
the true. Lord reserves the right to change the weather if he wants to.
Yes. yeah.
So
sometimes he needs to. Yeah.
That's my disclaimer as far as our weather forecast goes.
And that's a good disclaimer. That is a very good disclaimer. But let's pray that the weather that we have in the forecast, that he will still bless us with.
Absolutely.
It is 37 for the low tonight. But
wow.
Yeah. Just really nice. Nice weather all week.
I guess I don't need to
bring my mums
yet.
As long as it stays above 32, I'm fine.
Yeah,
me too.
Exactly. Don't have to worry about it freezing, right?
Me too.
That's right. Hey, you guys ready to do a riddle?
I am.
As opposed to a fiddle?
A fiddle, yes. A Friday riddle we're going to have for you this morning. We got more crazy and great crazy prizes. It's not a crazy riddle today. You have to think about it, okay? But we got great prizes and not a crazy riddle today. It's kind of nice to have this riddle we'll have in a moment for you. We've got our God's Not Dead Bible book cover this morning, right? And what else do we have? We have a Water Wash coupon from Water Wash. Yeah. And you guys are trying to outdo yourself here. And a gift certificate from Ray's Doghouse in Fairfield. Those are our prizes this morning.
Good stuff.
And Funday Friday here on the Vine. So, yeah, good stuff this morning. And, yeah, it's not too much of a crazy riddle for you. I think you can maybe answer this one. All right, 895-3030. 895-3030. Again, if you'd like to wash your car, go eat, and cover your Bible from Daystar Christian Bookstore, that nice God's Not Dead 2 Bible cover, guys.
Yeah, what more could you want? Yeah.
Right there, 895-3030. For our Friday riddle, you ready for this, guys?
Yes.
Yep.
All right. Can you name 3 consecutive days without using the words Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, or Sunday?
I think you didn't say Saturday.
Now say it again.
I thought I did. Okay, no, can you name three? Let me repeat it again. Can you name 3 consecutive days without using the words Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday? There you go. Cover that up there. Can you name 3 consecutive days without using the words Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday? You're close.
Am I one third, two-thirds?
You're two-thirds, I would say. Hey, someone thinks they know. So let's see if we have a caller that knows. Good morning, caller. Who's this?
It's Mark.
Hey, Mark. How are you this morning?
Pretty good.
All right. Yes. Jimmy is right.
Jimmy's got it right.
Mark, we got some cool prizes here. Yeah, where are you calling from, first off?
Driving on the road.
Driving on the road. All right. Well, safe driving this morning. All right. What do you think our answer might be, Mark?
That would be yesterday, today, and today, and tomorrow.
Yep. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Think about it now.
Yeah. You had said what days, and I was referring to day when I first said it. And I said yesterday, today, and someday with day. But it's yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
Yeah,
That's good. Yeah. And Mark got that fast. You did.
Yeah. Have you heard that one before, Mark?
The what?
Have you heard that before? I have heard that one before. It's been a long time ago. I heard somebody mention that. But have you heard that one before?
Yes.
Yeah. I've heard it before. I've heard different ones talk about that.
Heard
yeah.
It.
Yeah. Yeah. 3 consecutive days without using the words Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Sunday. Yesterday, today, tomorrow. All right. Hey, congratulations, Mark. You just won some cool prizes here. We'll come back in a moment and get some information from you. All right?
All right.
Thanks. Yeah, that's Mark. He's on the road driving today.
Yeah, nice. He got that fast.
Yeah, he did. So congratulations to him. Water wash coupon from Mount Vernon, Ray's Doghouse gift certificate, and the God's Not Dead Bible book cover this morning as he wins those prizes from the Vine Morning Show. We're going to come back, and we'll be wrapping it up here pretty soon. Jimmy's going to come back. You've got 2 corny jokes for the day.
Since we didn't get to do it last week with the special interview that Randy and Brian had with Niles. So.
Yeah. Okay, all right. So we'll come back and wrap it up, and Jimmy will have his 2 corny jokes. All right, more to come this morning. The Vine Morning Show on this Funday Friday continues. Right now, time for Hope Out Loud with a member of the Barrick family. It's being underwritten by Monroe Accounting in McLeansboro.
Real Life Radio Foundation is blessed by the generosity of Monroe Accounting in McLeansboro. They specialize in a full line of accounting services for businesses, individuals, and farms, including tax preparation, payroll preparation, quarterly sales taxes, and more. Their office is located at 102 East Market Street in downtown McLeansboro, with experience and knowledge to serve your needs. Their phone number is 643-3993. Monroe Accounting in McLeansboro, a proud supporter of 90.9 and 105.5 The Vine.
Today on Hope Out Loud, Andy and Jen Barrick.
Because of our family's accident, we have a ministry that's touching lives every day. Thank God that we can make our plans, but the Lord determines our steps. Jen, pray for our friend listening today who needs to see how God wants to use them despite their own challenging setbacks.
Let's pray. Dear faithful Father, I want to uplift my friend listening to you this day, who may just feel weighed down by the trap of life and circumstances. Lord Jesus, thank you for how with you all things are possible. Thank you for being our one true security and hope.
Amen. Receive more encouragement with Jen's new prayer book, called Hope Out Loud Prayers. Learn more at hopeoutloud.com.
More music and ministry for Flora, McLeansboro, and Benton.
90.9 The Vine.
Orchardville Church is presenting the drama Judgment House. This live performance is a walk-through drama which effectively presents the gospel through a relevant and gripping story. Judgment House at Orchardville Church is the last two weekends of October. Dates and times are listed on our website at ochurch.com. Limited spots are available. Please hurry. Tickets are going fast. You can find us on Facebook or email us at tickets@ochurch.com. There is no charge. We look forward to seeing you at Orchardville Church's presentation of Judgment House. Invite your friends and family.
Local Christian radio for you and your family. 90.9 The Vine.
Another heartbreak day. Feels like you're miles away. Don't even need no shade when your sun don't shine. Shine. Too many passing dreams roll by like limousines. It's hard to keep believing when it pass you by and by. I know your heart been broke again. I know your prayers ain't been answered yet.
sweet mama say, shoot for the moon, my dear. So you took game out of this atmosphere. Between high stakes and pump fakes, you're feeling like you can't vibrate.
I can hold your hand, but I can't turn your eyes to freedom. He'll get you through this. Hold on, hold on. These are the promises I never will forget. I never will forget. So hold on, hold on. The Lord ain't finished yet. Hold on, hold on. He'll get you through this. Hold on, hold on. These are the promises I never will forget. I never will forget. I know your heart been broke again. I know your prayers ain't been answered yet.
Real Life Radio is thankful for the financial partnership we have with Greenwald & Sons Construction in Wayne City and in Mount Vernon. They specialize in residential and commercial construction and remodeling. They have a long list of satisfied customers spanning over 38 years. Whether it's a church addition, business expansion, or new home construction, Greenwald & Sons Construction of Wayne City and Mount Vernon are experts that you can depend on. Their phone number is 895-2044, and we thank them for their support of local Christian radio.
Huey Funeral Home in Mount Vernon is an underwriting supporter of The Vine, and they have a new website to serve your needs even better. You can actually subscribe to the obituary so that you stay informed, and the website features a celebration wall where you can leave condolences, order flowers, upload photos and videos, and much more. Huey Funeral Home has been trusted by Jefferson County since 1946. They're always ready to serve you in your time of need. Thoughtful, professional, and caring. That's Huey Funeral Home in Mount Vernon. Their website is hueyfh.com.
Real Life Radio is grateful for the underwriting support of Taylor Flooring in Mount Vernon. Located at 328 Main Street in Mount Vernon, Taylor Flooring specializes in the sales, service, and installation of top brands such as Mohawk, Southwind, and LW Mountain. 100% locally owned and operated by Mark and Sherry Taylor, Taylor Flooring in Mount Vernon has your flooring needs covered. Their phone number is 315-6004.
He who has an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. This is Keeping Watch with Laura Greathouse.
In the book of Revelation, there is an interesting verse talking about the witnesses that arrive during the end. And they will die, the Bible says. People from all tribes, languages, and nations will look upon them for 3.5 days, not permitting them burial. And those who live upon the earth will gloat over them. And understand this, it says they will celebrate and send gifts to one another because these two prophets had brought judgment. And they were glad these two were dead. And what seems so interesting to me and others about this is we are now witnessing a group of people that celebrate death of Christians and Jews by giving gifts to one another. An example of this is in April, when Hamas bombed an Israeli bus, injuring 21 people. And to celebrate, it was shown even on TV. They were passing out candy to one another and even to people in cars driving by. We couldn't say for sure who will end up killing the two witnesses spoken about in Revelation. But I wonder, regarding this verse saying they will exchange gifts after the death of these two witnesses, could this be an end-time biblical clue? Time will tell.
This has been Keeping Watch with Laura Greathouse. Heard twice daily on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine.
Thank you, Laura. As we get ready to wrap things up here this morning on The Vine Morning Show, we thank those listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine and then watching this morning on our live in-studio camera on our website at wvyn.org. Been a lot of fun this morning, Kelley and Jimmy. And
yes, it has, guys. Yeah. It's time to start our weekend.
Yes, beautiful weekend. We'll have that forecast for you here in a moment. You got a lot planned this weekend?
I do. I have a busy weekend.
Busy. Jimmy, yeah. Busy.
No, it's always busy.
Oh, yeah.
Doing something.
Yeah, something going
always
on.
Always
busy. What about you?
Oh, well, yep. Same thing. Yeah, busy. Yeah, something always going on.
A little bit
on,
of family
know.
Time, fun time. And work time.
Yeah. So, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Not
so,
necessarily in that order.
Not in that order. That's right. No particular order. Hey, we did not do a corny joke last week.
So we're blessed with two this week.
We have two from Jimmy.
That's right.
Two corny jokes today.
And they're season appropriate.
All right.
Okay, good.
All right. Well, let's see what we have here.
Okay. How do you fix a broken pumpkin?
How do you fix a broken pumpkin?
Yeah.
How do you fix a broken pumpkin?
Yeah. With a pumpkin patch.
Oh, my.
Okay. And now the second one. The second one is a VeggieTales one.
Oh, VeggieTales.
Oh, I love VeggieTales.
So, okay. Who helps the small pumpkins cross the street at school?
Who helps? Are you much on VeggieTales?
Who helps the small pumpkins
cross the street at school?
Oh, I've got to give up.
Crossers.
The crossing gourds.
The crossing gourds. It has something to do with crossing guards. I knew it had something to do with crossing guards, but
those
crossing
were absolutely
gourds.
Adorable.
Gourds. Those were good, Jimmy.
The first one I have to give my cousin Kate. Kate Massey, who lives down in Tennessee.
She had that one
for you. I have to give her
you?
Credit. She posted that on her Facebook page last week.
That
and
was
I said,
awesome.
I've got to use this for the Radio for Funday Friday.
Yes, so that was good.
That is good.
How do you fix a broken pumpkin?
Yep, with a pumpkin patch.
Okay, I got to tell that one to my granddaughter.
She'll love that. Yeah, that's good. Well, thank you. Those are good.
You're welcome.
Two corny jokes in a day.
And they wasn't even corny. They were pretty cute.
They were
cute.
Funny. They were cute jokes. Cute, corny jokes.
Yeah,
if you call
I thought they were kind of corny.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't think they were corny. I thought they were really good and cute.
Speaking of corny, Wes Clark and Grandma, The Onslaught tonight, 10 o'clock tonight and tomorrow night.
Oh yeah,
105.5 and 90.9. The Vine. No telling what those two will get involved in. Don't forget.
Probably get ready for trick or treat.
Grandma will be in there gourding the kitchen.
The kitchen.
Yeah. Now there's a corny joke right there.
Grandma gourding the kitchen. That's a good one. I like
making
that.
Pumpkin pie.
Pumpkin pie.
Yeah.
From her broken pumpkins.
That's right.
Yes.
That is right. Hey, beautiful weekend, for visiting pumpkin patches. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
59 today, tomorrow 65, 75 Sunday, then Monday 68, all under clear skies, guys.
Now, this is fire pit weather of the
weather.
Evenings.
That's right.
Yeah,
bonfire.
We went to the pumpkin patch last Sunday, and it was
too
nice.
Hot.
It was just way too hot.
You can't really enjoy it when you're sweating. You got to have a hoodie on to enjoy it.
Enjoy it. It's the weekend. Yeah, it's going to be fun. Have a great weekend, everyone. Jenny Lee is next with The Overflow. Have a great weekend, guys.
You too, guys.
Have a great weekend, all of our listeners and our viewers, as Jenny Lee is next with The Overflow. Have a great weekend. Always remember to read Scripture daily. Stay focused on God and His Word. Zach Williams, Chainbreaker, he's coming up next right here at The Vine.